Welcome back, everybody, to the Jacksonville podcast, where shit happens and we do shit all over the place. Whatever. I'm your host, Toriel Jackson, and I'm joined here currently by basically the voice actor for Kamaru and Frosty, the voice actor for Genocide Jack. And where Faded gets trauma, yes. And I'm pretty sure, and both of them do not have their mics on right now. I do not know where Octakura is. Fluffy was just on. I have no idea what's going on. So please, everybody, fill me in. Where is everybody? Oh, that's Frosty.
I do not have any clue.
You have no clue where anybody is right now?
I do not.
I know someone's in Puerto Rico right now.
Yeah. And then, I don't know where the others are.
I don't know either. Toko, I don't know. Barry Hill isn't going to make it. Fade will be late, and I don't know where Fluffy is. Fluffy was just on. I do not know why you put Octo twice.
You put Octo twice because of reasons unknown?
Yes, absolutely reasons unknown.
Oh yeah, you want me to read some more messages that me and my friend sent?
No.
They're not weird. They're not weird, trust me.
Ah, yes. I should trust the person who is the horniest out of the entire group here.
Okay, so I was like, okay, I'm back. I'm back from, doing something. And they're like, welcome back, dear. Like, thank you for welcoming me back, sweetheart. Then they're like, anything for my beloved. And then they send, like, a gif of this character from Demon Slayer, like, doing maid work. And they're just like, me when we get married, trying to make you dinner and clean the house. I'm like, don't worry, I'll do that. And then they put, we, correcting me. We will cook together. In other words, you will cook and I will just cling on to you 24/7.
Oh my god.
And then I'm just like, my love, that sounds amazing. And they're like, I know, right? At least one of us will have the brains.
At least one of you.
And then they're like, you, right? And I'm like, that role belongs to you, sweetheart. And they're like, nah. And I'm like, then who would it go to? You or our future cat? And I was just like, what would we name him or her? And then they're just like, they just type a bunch of gibberish. Like, my brain is not working all of a sudden. Don't worry, sweetheart. Just relax. Thanks a lot, darling. And then they had to go after that because they live in Germany, different time zones.
I see. You're leaking your group chat right now.
This is relationship is purely platonic, trust me.
Yes. Purely platonic.
Purely platonic, okay? Just because we talked about getting married and we keep using words like my love, sweetheart, and dear, that does not mean anything.
Okay.
Purely platonic relationship.
Purely platonic, yes. Anyways, I think we should wait on Faded and maybe Fluffy join in for a second. Frosty be like from Little Miss Perfect Trend. What? It's totally platonic. Yeah, I know.
Listen, just because we talk about making out and kissing and stuff does not mean that we're in a relationship.
Just because he fucked my ass once doesn't mean that we are in a relationship.
Exactly. because he fucked my ass doesn't mean that he actually fucked my ass.
Ah, yes, absolutely. What a wonderful time.
Well, I'm
Anyway.
going to listen. I'm going to Maxor's summary of Ultra Kill. Definitely. Basically, his brain has left the fucking chat.
Yes, mine
Makes
has
sense.
too.
My other friend, we are playing Truth or Dare, and they dared me to send this to a random person, so I just sent it. I just put up, made a wheel, and then I sent it to the person it landed on. It was like, "Are you math? Because we should add a bed, subtract their clothes, divide your legs, and multiply."
Of course.
Oh, it wasn't. I didn't come up with it this time, I swear.
Ah, yes, you didn't come up with
He didn't. It was all my other friend.
sure.
Guarantee it.
Guaranteed, absolutely. Anyways. So,
Bro, Maxor.
Max was just on off the chain, just all the time.
How does he,
Absolutely.
bro? I swear, every 0.8 seconds, there's another edit, and I feel like I'm gonna have a seizure every second of the video.
Yep.
I only learned about Maxor because his Genshin Impact summary got like a tons of views and became really
Oh my
popular.
God, no fucking way. Here comes Octo. Octo's
Where?
here. I did not expect you to show up, my friend.
I woke up, so that's why.
I woke up to the sound of Toriel's ping. Ding!
No, I knew.
Aim goes as hard as diamonds.
So, also, I was wondering, why is there like a little voice?
Your
Or
mic quality is absolutely
what do you expect?
That expect was the only clear word from that.
Kuru Kuru.
If airplane pirates be like,
So, anyways, how are you?
Oh, balls.
Hello.
Anyways, where are
Huh? I can hear you perfectly fine.
Guys, I don't mean to be weird, but I think I can hear my neighbors having sex through the walls right now. What in the fuck? So, let me explain. I'm in my mom's closet, which is literally like right next to like the neighbors. It's like literally the wall is like at least 10 inches wide. Anyways, like we're basically right next to each other, and all I hear is banging coming from their bedroom.
You did not need to know that information, but apparently you just said it
Well, all right. So, anyway, where are we right now? The story.
Where are
He
we?
just kind of started.
Well, I haven't even started yet because
Where we
Faded's gonna
left
be
off.
late. Where we left off, you mean?
Yeah.
So, you guys just successfully defended the laboratory. Fluffy absolutely went Giga Chad. You guys walked back to the laboratory now. And now you're back in the hangar bays. About to be
Right.
loaded on the trucks. And then there goes Frosty.
Bruh.
And Frosty's back.
So, yeah.
Ba-da-ba-bum. Yes.
Okay, now there you go. It's working.
What in the fuck? Okay. We're gonna wait on Faded before we begin. And I hope you got my ping for hope you guys got my ping for the major update for
we can either make a new ultimate from Ultra Kill or Genshin Impact.
Yes. So you guys have to all of you have to have a consensus. All of you have to make a consensus.
See, look, Octo, here's the thing. Listen, you know about Ultra Kill and stuff, right? But I don't know anything about Ultra Kill. I can't really come to a decision.
Frosty, listen to me very carefully. If you want, explain Ultra Kill like 5 seconds.
Well, Frosty's currently watching Maxor, so I'm pretty sure Maxor is going to explain everything.
All right.
It was
Maxor's video on Ultra Kill, and you will find out what the fuck it is. And you're like, huh, me? Oh shit, this is actually lit.
I wonder how the mic quality is gonna pick up on the other end.
I'll do shit since I'm recording.
But like, my argument is Uba Sword Lady with super strong sword that somehow, when you play as her in game, can't one shot everything at level 1, which is bullshit. Right.
Yeah.
Alright, fair point. But
that's my argument. I'm joking. That was a joke, I swear.
I have a fair counter argument. Have you considered stealing a coin as a form of martial arts?
Hmm.
Alright. I just can't hear stop by and say, oh, yeah, that's pretty much it.
That's all you came by to do? You didn't come to... That's all you came by to do?
Yeah.
You just came by to say hi.
Okay, that's a lie. I came by for the session. However, I'll be right back.
Oh, okay.
Oh. Right. Oh, Jesus. Oh, my goodness.
Oh my god, what in the hell is going on?
Oh my god!
What?
Malicious face.
Post his face.
I think my copy of Elden Ring is broken.
Alright, I'm gonna try DMing Fluffy.
Right in after canonically having one of the strongest sword art techniques in the whole world, capable of one-shotting almost everything, but when you pull her in,
Queen Raiden
can't even do 30 damage.
Yep, that's how DRU works. Welcome to the real world.
My shine's eternal.
I've seen people do like 70k with Raiden before.
Hello, my fellow girls. Welcome to level 2. We have Amazon.
All right,
bro, it's missing a Columbina's lullaby. Frosty,
right?
Columbina's lullaby, slay.
Yes.
Oh my god. Jesus Christ.
By the way, you guys are very close to end of prologue.
Yeah.
So much violence.
Oh, it's only gonna get more violent.
Sus imposter.
Yes.
Are you a sussy imposter?
So right now you're on the enlisted mission. of the prologue. And yes, I have everything.
Oh, my YouTube career.
Yes, enlisted.
Do not Google Danger Force Season 2, Episode 1.
Yes, Google that specifically. Everyone Google it.
No.
Same here, anyways.
My goodness.
Since the primary focus of the party is here, and Fluffy isn't here yet, all you have to do, we don't really need to wait on Faded. We can just go ahead and start once Octo gets back. And I know we seem to be starting late, everybody, but life, and life is a bitch.
Oh my god.
Also, I'm going to be making a video tomorrow. I can't wait for you guys. It's going to be animated in the style of how I'm going to do Salsa Lost Season 2. I see that, basically. So, it's going to be animated in the style that I'm going to do it for Salsa Lost, you know, Salsa Lost Season 2. So, yeah. It's gonna be called Salsa Lost Zero Gundam Cucks Sonya.
Christ.
My god.
Yes. It's gonna be a whole video. My god.
Sonya, never mind.
Yes, cucking Sonya, never mind.
Oh my god.
The best thing possible.
It's Kamaichi getting cucked.
Of course. It might release tomorrow, or it might release Saturday or Sunday, because animating with sprites is a bitch, so especially on the type of animation app I have. So I'm pretty sure all of you guys will enjoy it. I pretty much voice everybody. Except for, yeah, actually, I can pretty much voice everybody. I might get, everybody that's in the video. I might get Barry Hill to be Nagito, because Nagito's in it, but that's pretty much it. There's not that many characters in this episode.
My god! Everything, there's just so much explosion on the screen.
You are watching Maxor. That makes a lot of sense.
Sorry, what was that?
I was saying, yeah, you are watching.
Respect.
I said, that makes sense because you're watching Maxor. Anyways.
What the fuck is happening?
Everything and anything all at once.
Getting the gritty.
What?
You won't understand. While we're waiting on Octo, you just want me want me to just put on an activity and just play Maxor's video? While we wait on the... Watch just Maxor while we wait on the Octo to come back?
I don't know what the fuck is happening, but it's funny.
And you have to watch it 3 times, understand? Post is rocked, instantly become funny.
Crack.
Hey, Frosty. Nice to meet you. My name's Nahida. I've actually been watching you for quite some time now.
Yes.
What? That's a character from Genshin Impact.
Well, I haven't played it yet. And I'm now forced to get it for a stream Guardian next Wednesday.
Of hell.
Yay!
What is this? Wait, what?
I love how Barry Hill voted for Genshin Impact still.
I can't believe I'm going to be playing Genshin Impact.
It's
you better
good.
Get ready to load up that Chinese malware, boy.
Yep.
Genshin is good. It is good. It is good.
Yes. Genshin is good. It might be good, but... And I don't... If every one of you or majority votes for Genshin Ultimate over Ultra Kill Ultimate, or Ultra Kill Ultimate over Genshin Ultimate, I'll have to stack up on the lore of both of them in order to properly add their quest lines to the game.
Genshin.
Well, it really depends on what character. Okay, so I'm gonna speak from Genshin's side. It really depends what character. If Genshin wins, it really depends what character we bring in from there.
Yes.
Every character has, like, a whole fucking book of lore.
They do.
Every character has trauma. I swear, every character has trauma, no matter how small or big it is.
Specifically the anime children.
Literally all the animal characters, someone in their life died, and then they got an animal vision.
Bro, but remember how...
Uh-oh, my friend died. I guess I'm just going to become a wind person now.
Remember how in each nation so far, how the Traveler got saved by some sort of, like, you know, animal character? And remember that one line Venti said?
May the wind protect you.
May the wind bless your travels.
It might either be a Genshin character, or I might make up one that is based around Genshin.
Like, after playing Genshin and stuff, I'm just gonna have to try and make something.
Same thing over, and, same thing over with the, like, Ultra Kill Ultimate. But that's, like, the major update's, like, the Another update. That's, like, with Danganronpa.
Oh, yeah, the Another, so.
Yeah.
Okay, for example... Let me remember a character. So there's this character named Dory, right? On the surface, she just looks like a greedy little, like, rich person, right?
But Dory.
Under her facade, her sister, when she was young, had a deadly disease. She was in poverty, so she couldn't pay for medication. So now when she grew up, she's trying to become the richest person in Teyvat. So if anything like that happens to any of her loved ones, she has enough money to pay for treatment.
I know. So I thought that actually her reason for being pretty greedy with money is actually really sweet.
Yes. Absolutely sweet.
Wholesome.
Completely wholesome.
And then there's this one character that she put into, like, debt or something because, like, he couldn't pay for the materials that, like, he made her palace out of.
Yeah.
And even then, that guy has a bunch of trauma, too. It's like, I think his dad went to the desert one time, and then he died. And then his mother just, like, stopped doing her job, so then they became poor. And then she, like...
One of the characters that I think has the worst trauma, personally, is Kale.
Yeah, Kale literally got, like, taken away at a young age and got experimented on by Dottore for, like, years.
I know.
I'm a non-Genshin person, and you are doing a fantastic job of explaining the lore.
Read the manga.
It's like, it's hard to explain, really, but, like, I'd have to, like, read their character stories word for word. Actually explain it correctly, but
Rossi, out of all the Genshin characters, who do you think has the worst trauma?
I don't know, that's hard to tell because half the characters literally went through
terrible trauma.
One of them got abandoned by their mom, okay? That's not even the worst of it. Got abandoned by his mom. Two of his closest friends died.
Fainted. Hooray, finally.
Oh, are you okay?
You're going to love what's going to happen.
It was lonely.
Very lonely.
Days. They're so dark.
We haven't even started DRU yet. We were waiting on... Oh, Octo came back at around the same fucking time. Yes, we can finally start session. We can finally start all session. Right.
Okay. Yeah, guitar.
All right.
Haven't even heard of Ultra Kill. So also,
am.
Say this. You cannot understand.
Max or literally went by default.
Alright, so I mean, are we ready?
From what I've seen, I think I can understand why Octo is going to choose Ultra Kill.
Because it's badass.
Yeah, pretty much. My argument is that one of the weakest gods out of the seven was once powerful enough to cut through mountains and decided to create a whole archipelago.
Here's the thing. V1 killed a bunch of prime spirits, which are canonically the strongest.
Fought a fucking
spirits.
Angel. Fought a biblically accurate angel.
One of the gods in Genshin Impact.
He fought several prime souls.
He's one of the greatest characters to have on the Genshin team.
Let's stop arguing over Genshin Overkill. Let's do it in our active typing channel, and let's actually start this shit. Oh. How about, what do you guys think? You guys want to start DRU?
Yes.
Alright.
I feel like we have enough people now.
Yes, we do have enough people. Alright. Let's do this. So, you guys have just gotten, for people who are on the roof, this included Julian and Rio. Rio just got a proper drink in order to heal her energy. And Jack is also somewhat carrying her on her shoulders because she's very weak from the angel's blood she consumed. And then Julian's following behind. Obviously still. Well, Julian's falling behind with his limited edition Monokuma 2010 Trigger Happy Habits.
Hold on. You said it wrong. It's the limited edition Monokuma 2010 deluxe version, enhanced edition 2.0, Nintendo.
Fluffy's coming.
God damn, bro.
Alright, so Avon is coming in alongside Rogers from the front door, both of them looking badass as hell. Filled with blood and gore covering them. So they enter from the front doors while our good old pals from the roof came downstairs. Finn! That was very eventful, don't you think? All of you? Do you not think that was very eventful?
I zoned out for a second. Can you repeat that?
Well, that was very eventful. Don't you guys think so?
I mean, like, I lost my giant hammer. So.
And what about you, person who's playing the Switchback, sir?
I mean, I like looking at I meant what?
I was asking you how if that was very eventful or not.
Oh yeah, very.
And what about you, my friend, my lady?
My lady.
She's just coming in and out of consciousness. Then, it seems you guys are very tired, but of course, Jiro demanded that you go to the military district. So, everyone onto the troop transport. He points over to the troop transport truck, which instead of it being painted a deep green, it's painted a black. With, of course, the sigil of the Shadow Marines on the very front. Which I'll find the sigil for the Shadow Marines. I think I found it one day. And I'll send it in chat so you guys can actively imagine what it looks like on all of their flags and stuff. But you guys load into the troop transport. The door closes behind you guys. And Jackvik hits the side of it. Bang, bang. And the troop transport goes through the danger zone. Guys don't really have. There's no windows in the back of the troop transport, so yeah. We'll go ahead and have a conversation. Go ahead, have your characters conversate with each other, or talk to each other.
Do you consider jacking off as a form of a sport?
No, because I was typing something in TikTok in another tab, and I forgot. My computer's so stupid, when I switch to another tab, it starts typing in the closest text box.
Is this in-game, or...
This is in-game.
Oh, all right. That was
unfair. Do you consider...
I gotta go for a bit. I'm babysitting.
Oh,
boy.
So Rio just passes out. Boy. So, go ahead.
So, Frosty, my homeboy, my brother in law, do you consider jacking off as a form of a sport?
I almost spat on my drink.
Avon was asking Julian if he considers jacking off a form of sport.
Consider jacking off a form of sport?
Yes. Are you not paying attention?
I was listening to my family argue downstairs.
God damn, bro.
Damn, what the hell is going on? Your neighbors are banging right behind your wall. Families arguing downstairs. What a wonderful time.
All right.
Okay, sorry. So, if you want my honest opinion, yes.
You do think so.
He said yes.
Definitely. I mean, like, you gotta see who could last the longest, you know?
Rogers is also...
Exactly.
Rogers is also passed out. And Avon, he's seated next to you. You then see this big hunk of metal just sway. And then finally, he's now falling towards you as he's about to fall down to sleep.
Switch sides of the seat.
He switched sides. The falling Roger stops. Then he immediately lays on you. That's tons of metal just laying on you, Avon.
Do you need help?
So Avon's being crushed by a sleeping Rogers, and he can't wake Rogers up. Julian's just playing on a switch. And then there's Rio, who's also passed out.
Let's see, what can I do here? I grab a sword and use it as like a fucking car jack.
I'm trying to pull out Roger's sword, but it seems to be stuck inside of its hilt. Ba-dan, da-dan.
I lift him up.
Try lifting him up. Oh, strength check time. Do you have your notes?
I'm in Puerto Rico. I left my notes behind.
Of course you did.
However, if I remember correctly, my strength is a 3. So.
Didn't you level up?
I did level up. Yeah, my strength is now a 5. I forgot.
Alright, your strength is a 5. No way! I did. No way! You have exactly enough strength to lift him off of you back to a sitting position.
Pretty
sure all of you are tired for today because, well, first off, and just today, you woke up in the middle of the beach. You met this guy. He punted some dude named Kokichi. Good old Faded ended up experiencing some trauma and pain. You guys went all across literally a gate and you fought Casper the Unfriendly Piss. You died, then woke up, fought back against the Horde, and you're in a troop transport heading directly back or heading directly to the military district to go see Jiro. A lot has happened on day fucking one.
God, it was day one, huh?
Welcome back, basically.
Yep, welcome back, basically.
Basically.
Footballs.
Yep, this is day one. Rio wakes up, by the way.
Rio, my friend. Hey, random question.
Huh? Where are we?
A lot is going on. No, everyone's in.
No, I don't. Okay, sure.
Hold up.
Just go with it.
I got to go to a private area.
Don't need to act like my character is possessed or I'm not just in my head now. You'll see, Faded. You'll see. We'll get to you in a second. Frosty! So when can I suck someone's dick? Absolutely glorious.
Sorry, my friend.
It's an honest question.
Go, Octo was asking something to Rio.
The question.
Fluffy!
Oh, Fluffy! So, Rogers finally wakes up from his little nap in the middle, in the troop transport.
I do the whole fucking Dark Souls monologue, like, you're finally awake. You are fucking crushing me.
Anyways,
Avery
was
asking
Rio a
question,
so go ahead,
Avery.
Go
ahead, Avery.
Sam.
Oh, hey, Fluffy.
Hi.
Why do you have blue hair?
Blue hair?
You kind of remind me of the Monday Sam.
It's just the way I was born.
Even fight demons right now.
Did you honestly forget I'm a water kitsune? Babysitting problems.
Oh, shit.
What the fuck?
Rio then passes out again.
How can there be a waterfall? Like, is that an animal fall waterfall?
You have no idea, but one thing is for certain. You guys, the truck slows down as you guys approach the gates to the military district. They open, and the troop transport stops. Ultimates, please exit. Then someone opens the big doors, and you guys, part of the party, have never seen the military district before, but you see this wondrous beauty. This wondrous amazement you only see in a military base. And you see a glorious orange sunset beaming out of the waters as you see jets flying in the sky, a massive mothership the size of a fucking state. There's giant robots, there are some tanks, you know, the standard military shit.
Oh, I look at the giant robots. Holy shit, they recruited the Autobots.
Autobots roll out.
Nice Transformers reference. Nice Transformers reference, Ultimate, says one of the guards.
Of course.
Not a Transformer. That's a Jaeger. It's one of our Titan fighting robots.
So you're telling me along with zombies, we gotta fight a fucking Godzilla?
Well, sometimes we fight kaijus. So, you guys are being escorted by about 5 different Shadow Marines, each of them holding G3 battle rifles, and they're decked out in military gear, but all the military gear is either black or white. Mostly it's all black and white, in some way. They then are transporting you directly to the Central Intelligence Agency. And over the building, you see half of that shit is blown.
Holy goddamn macaroni, what the fuck happened here?
Jiro, in his words, our emperor, our great and mighty emperor, in his words, said, He slept a hoe.
That man was clapping cheeks so hard that he booked the time and space of the multiverse.
The Shadow Marines laugh at your joke.
Agent with Morgan's coming by zero. Cheeks clapping.
They escort you to the Center Intelligence Building. Two Shadow Marines open the double doors, and as you guys enter, the same thing that Faded and Leslie had witnessed happens to you guys. Shadow Marines exit every door, they pull their battle rifles into position, they go like, Ultimates! And then they all kneel down on one knee.
I look at him and go, look, I may be an old. I don't know why you consider me an ultimate. I'm just a regular dude. Alright?
Well, you are an ultimate.
How the fuck am I an ultimate? I guess I can be purple? The ultimate purple guy?
Our great and mighty emperor said you were an ultimate, so we refer to you as ultimate.
Alright. I'm gonna have to talk to you later, y'all.
So,
anyways,
two of the guards from the group end up escorting you down the hallway. They then open the doors to the interrogation room. Frosty and Leslie are both absent. However, out of all three of you, Rio, being Rio, Rogers, and Octo, and Julian, all four of you have entered the room, and Jiro's sitting down at a table, legs crossed, feet up, hands behind his head, leaning back on a chair, while two demon dogs, which you haven't seen the demon dogs yet, these massively black armored soldiers, are holding guns that are the size of Roger. Like, they're massive.
Hey, Roger, I think I found the cousins.
Wow, they do look like me.
He's so mean.
One of them is missing his helmet. One of them has his helmet on his waistband, along with a katana, a weird looking one. And of course, he looks a tiny bit like Faded. Not a lot, not by a lot, but by some degree, he looks somewhat like Faded.
Okay.
Hey! Look who finally made it! I'm guessing you guys died on your way over. I'm guessing you guys died on your way over to the military district. But fret not, my friends. Welcome to your interrogation.
Why are the interrogations so depressing?
Why
are you alive?
Why am I interrogating you? Well, just to get to know who you are, so your friends know who you are. Because guess what? You gotta tell me. I'm gonna start with one by one. You guys are gonna tell me about yourselves.
Okay, just give me a minute. I want to try to live up the room, you know, not make it a little bit depressing.
It isn't really depressing, it's more like an interrogation room.
Yes, but is there a cooler nearby?
A cooler?
Yes.
In here? Not in here, but there's a water dispenser outside. Oh yeah, also for those who didn't DM me your backstories yet, go ahead and DM me your character's backstories.
Even you have your backstory? I'm gonna be for real, feel terrifying. Even! What? Alright, we gotta make one on the spot. Thank you, stupid.
I know you don't have a backstory, Avon. It's alright, buddy. You're just someone who owns... You're just someone from a different world, a different dimension, who owns a cartoon studio. And let me guess. Nice. The year in your world is 1962.
You are so very wrong. You're a fucking idiot.
Am I?
Yes, you actually are. That's not what I was going to go for.
Yeah, you're right. I'm fucking with you. He then slaps his knee. Oh. Sometimes I crack myself up because you look like a 1960s cartoon.
I'm 15. From where I am, it's 2023.
Yeah. You're a bit too much of an enigma for me. Jiro then has this bit of creepy smile. Like, this guy has that crazy smile, that Junko crazy smile. And his eyes twitching a bit. Well, absolutely. Him. He then starts tapping his finger rapidly, his middle finger rapidly on the table. He's getting very antsy. His foot is absolutely out of the fritz. Keep on stomping the floor. These demon dog shadow marines step back against the wall.
Dude, if you just want my backstory, I can literally give you a piece of paper that has it right here as I pull out the fucking script.
Ah, yes! He then calms his demeanor. Ah, yes, thank you very much. He then holds out his hand. Please, gift it to me.
I was literally just standing here.
I guess I gotta go switch places now, because
oh, the notepad I was using somehow crashed, and now I gotta retype.
Damn, you guys gonna take a fucking while.
Alright,
if I keep hearing that banging noise,
So do you guys want to wait until... You guys want to cut over... Want me to go ahead and cut over to... Faded real quick while you guys are getting your backstories.
Yeah.
All right. Faded?
Hold on. I gotta. Okay, turn off my light, turn off my LED light, sit in darkness. Okay, I'm ready.
Okay. Here we go. All right. You return to consciousness in the bathroom. There is nobody inside.
What happened?
You then look to the mirror and you see the torn assassin instead of your own reflection.
I haven't, Vitalina.
What?
Goodness.
No. What did you do to me?
I didn't do anything.
He then points over to Jiro's passed out body, his arm on the sink, literally holding up a middle finger where his arm is on the sink. He's holding a middle finger up to wherever your direction is.
Can I hold up the middle finger back?
You can. Jiro's passed out. He won't do shit.
I'll do that then.
Hold the middle finger to Jiro.
I seem to have taught you well. The process is just beginning. You see, my little Fatalina. I can't trust you to fulfill your promise. So, I was gifted orders. Orders from my queen. To go ahead and just take your body.
What? It hasn't even been a day. Why don't you think I can do the job?
Well, I just got these orders, like, what, an hour ago?
Oh my god.
It's been 10 years since I was first gifted these orders to make a deal with you. And I'm guessing, you know, I hate last minute shit. You can understand that at least. Don't you just hate it when someone, like your boss, gives you a last-minute order?
Well, I mean, I haven't been part of a job before.
Well, yes, but don't you hate it when someone gives you information last minute while you're doing the thing?
Just get to the point already.
I've taken your body, and once I have, I can go kill your mother. Well, you had an opportunity to, but you kind of lagged. And you passed out.
Well, gee, I wonder what happened while I was in the military base. You didn't give me enough time. It's only been a few fucking hours.
Tortoise asks and then just goes ahead. Doesn't do an angry frown, instead does a regular frown like,
Damn, actually, fuck. You are right.
Exactly. Exactly.
Well, my mistake. Everyone makes mistakes. And sometimes I just hate being patient. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
No. Sleep!
He then passed out again.
Oh, great. Yeah, here, hold on. Let me grab my water bottle. Hold on, let me turn back on my light, because it is way too dark. And let me just... I'm gonna bonk my water bottle over my head and just mute.
Why?
Because I can.
Why are you muting?
Because I don't know if it's my turn
It is gonna be your turn.
Okay, never mind then. I will stay conscious.
Good. So, you, of course, reawaken in this massive circular looking floor. It's elevated in a dark, empty void. The floor is made out of this greenish, jadeish material. You haven't seen it before. Especially the symbols on the floor, reminiscing of a family as ancient and old as time.
Jesus, everything has to be green. First my blood and flames, and now this? Boring.
What? It's my gimmick.
You can see the torn assassin start approaching you from the end of this arena.
Well, it's an ugly gimmick.
Fuck you.
I'll return the favor back.
If you are, then...
Did I hear someone say fuck you?
Shut up!
If they insist...
Look at his ass! Do you want to fuck dead flesh?
I mean, you gotta try something. You gotta, like, you know, there's a first time for everything.
Nah! That's necrophilia.
Now I'm remembering when you said the zombie thing.
Yeah.
Y'all, there's a first time for everything.
Oh,
look,
my
let Faded and Torn Assassin cook. Let Faded and Torn Assassin cook, Frosty.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, let me cook. Oh my god.
No.
So, I can't just take over your body now. Besides, where's the development for that? It has only been a day. Now that I think about it, jeez, I've been fucking you up for a day. God. Is this even normal? Whatever. I'm just tired of waiting around for everything.
He then grabs the hilt of his scythe. He then slams his scythe down onto the jade arena and makes a crater.
God.
He then extends out his bone blade.
And now... I'm going to make you run a trial. test. I want to see how strong you are.
Oh, god dang it, I accidentally hit the wrong button. God dang it.
Yeah, I don't know why you're pressing that.
Called accidentally. Okay, there's something called accidents.
Alright, so. Actual boss fight. This is a trial boss fight. In front of you, from the sky, in a twirling motion, lands a knife. Actually, it's not a knife. You know what? I'm gonna scratch that. It's a kunai. Or it's five kunais.
Hmm.
These kunais are of a jaded material. Welcome to the fucking boss fight. The real one. By the way, all rights belong to the original copyright holders for the song. The Torn Assassin. This motherfucker's a late game boss, so guess how much health this dude has. Take a guess.
I gotta take a guess?
Yeah, take a guess. Go ahead, I'll tell you if you're wrong.
I'm just gonna take a random guess. 600k?
750,000.
Okay, so I'm like 150,000 off, not bad.
You are right. So, you ready?
No.
Of course you aren't, but you're still going to do it anyways. Your move first.
God.
Go ahead.
I'm gonna just grab one of the kunais off the ground.
You're gonna grab one of them?
Yeah.
Is that your action?
Mm-hmm.
Alright. Yes. That's your action. Got it. So now it's his turn. So let's see. Let me count how many moves this dude has on phase one. Oh yeah, he only has three. So. He grabs his scythe, twirls it around, twirls it to his shoulder, brings it around behind him, and then comes in for a swing. Roll for instinct.
Oh god, that's right, I gotta grab my dice.
Yeah, get a d20.
There it is. It's in my card game box. Why? I have no clue. I gotta pull my stuff out.
Genius invocation.
Don't ask.
BCG.
Okay. That's it.
Jesus Christ, I didn't realize how much. Whoa, I didn't realize 11. How much I wrote.
Damn.
What?
Alright, You looking for your dice faded?
No, I rolled, I got an 11.
Oh, you got an 11? Alright.
Yeah.
So he swung, and you jumped, and you did a literal cartwheel flip over his scythe blade. You landed on your feet.
Hey.
It's your turn again.
Okay, I take the kunai that I throw off, that I got off the ground, and I throw it at him.
Alright, you take your kunai, you throw it at him, right? What's your accuracy? Yes.
I believe I sent you it. It's a 4, I think.
Yep, your accuracy is a 4. Alright, so I'm a roll, and if it's over, I'll give you a chance to roll, okay?
Oh.
Alright, go ahead and roll.
I didn't interrupt, but I didn't realize how much I wrote until I pasted it into chat.
Oh my god.
Yeah. You probably did not know.
Because I wrote so much to the point where it says I only have 68 words left.
Damn. God, that's gonna be a lot to
get
read.
Get this.
So what's
roll,
your
look at the chat.
What's your roll faded?
Got a 9.
You got a 9. Fantastic. You had to roll a 5.
Woo!
So you hit him with the kunai. So, roll a d100 to see how much damage you do. And also multiply that D100 by 10, since he's weak to jade weapons. You're holding jade weapons.
Hold on. Crap. 75, so 75 times 10.
Times 10.
750.
750. Alright. So hold on. Give me a second. Doing some math. Alright. So 750 minus that. Got it. You took away 750 of his health. Now he's at 749,250 health. It stabs him directly into his shoulder. He gets taken aback from that. Fuck!
Take the L, bozo.
He growls. You're a bit too close. So he's about to pull the wombo combo at you. He has 3 turns now.
Wombo combo, happy feet, stickman, punch.
Alright, so here's what he's gonna do.
Okay.
He's gonna bring up his scythe, go down the overhead strike. Not gonna hit it enough where it makes a crater and makes a cratering AoE effect. But instead, he's gonna hit it down, it's gonna lightly tap, then he's gonna let go from one of his hands, swing with his other, and then he's gonna spin around and do one final swing from the back. So roll 3 times for instinct.
Okay, remember these. 13, 13 again, and 2.
God damn. Holy shit. So, when he does the overhead swing, you dodge to the side. When he comes in for the one-handed swing, recovering from that overhead, you literally limbo under the scythe blade, and then he comes around with a twist, and then you do a full body lay down. You put your hands behind your back, and you jump back up on your 2 feet.
That's how it's done.
He craters the ground from where his scythe landed. He looks over his shoulder.
Seems your excesses instincts never fail you, Fatalina.
Ig fucking exactly.
Alright, your turn, Faden.
Okay, I still have my normal kunais, right?
Yes, you do. And he did rip out the jaded kunai and threw it on the floor. There are 5 jade kunais on the floor now, so you can go pick all of them up. He's 10 times weak to jaded weapons, so.
Yeah, I'll go and pick all of them up.
You're gonna use your move to pick them all up?
Yes.
Alright, let's see. Do you need to roll for any of that? Yeah, do a speed check. Let's do a speed check. Your speed, is,
speed
a 3.
Is a 3.
Alright. Go ahead and roll. You have to beat a 15.
God. I got a 7.
You got a 7. Alright, so. So your, let's look. Your vigor is 10, so you have 200 health. Good. So. You grab 3 of them, though. You grab 3 of the jade kunais. But then he catches you and clothesline you from the neck. You take only 10 damage. You have 190 health left.
Ow.
Take that, you fucking bitch.
There's something called sarcasm. Have you heard of it? Try looking at a dictionary.
I'm Muslim. I don't read dictionaries.
Exactly, that's how dumb you are. Oh, what? Someone's getting mad now?
It's his turn. He has 3 turns. You're taunting him now.
Yeah, I know. I know he needs a taste of his own medicine.
Alright, I'm gonna have to roll a D100 to see if he lands this move. It takes only one of his turns, though. Let's see. Where the fuck is going?
The torn assassin just starts wave dashing.
starts fucking wave dashing. Alright, gotta restart. So, let me turn on my light real quick. Found it. Alright, I need to go turn on my light. Not shown, baby. Alright, there we go. Alright, my light's on. Now I can roll it. And make sure I get you an accurate read on it. A out of what? Ooh, he didn't make it. Okay, so his first attack he didn't do. Instead, he's gonna try for another one. So he then jumps up to the sky. He jumps up very high into the sky, pulls his scythe backwards, and throws it at you. Roll for instinct.
14.
He got a 10? A 14?
No, 14. Yeah.
You dodged the initial scythe. He then somersaults to the scythe, grabs it from the hilt, comes in for an overhead strike. Go ahead and roll another instinct.
8.
An 8. You dodge that. You then sidestep out of the way.
Fly to the left. Fly to the right.
You got dodged for days. Damn.
I know, bro.
So you dodge that attack. It's now your turn.
Okay, can I throw 2 of the Jade Kunais at him?
Yes, you can. You can throw 2 of the Jade Kunais at once if you'd like to. This means it doubles your initial damage. From just one. Alright, you gonna throw?
Okay, I'll do that, yeah.
Alright, your accuracy is a 4. I'm gonna roll. And then give you a chance to... 13. Go ahead and roll to beat one. Beat that.
Come on.
What'd
16.
You get? You got a 16. Damn. All right. Roll a D100. Multiply that by 2. And then multiply that 2 by 10.
Come on. Times 2. Then times 10.
Yes.
1,780.
1,780. He's now at 747,470 health.
Oh man, this is...
You hit him in the chest. And then the other kunai hits him square in the forehead. And that kunai gets him on his knees. You then hear a crack! He gets on his knees holding your scythe with one hand. His poise is broken. Do you want to take this chance to do a critical strike?
Yeah. You know what? YOLO. YOLO.
You're gonna do it? Let's see if you succeed.
Yeah.
Alright, you got a... It's a speed check. Roll for the speed check.
Alright. 11.
11. Oh, damn. So, you take the one kunai, Jade Kunai you had, flipped it around like a ninja, hit the dash, but the torn assassin grabs your hand before you're able to execute it. He then looks up at you with a sinister grin. You then hear a ching, and a glint comes to his eye, and then he gut checks you. He punches you directly in the gut. You feel that shit. That takes away 10 damage, but now he's gonna do something. He swings around his scythe and hits you, and the scythe blade makes contact with your side, piercing through your stomach.
God!
Alright, what's your poise?
Oh, I don't think I have that down yet. If not, I can add it real quick.
I'm not adding your poise yet.
Yeah, no, I didn't do it yet. Since I have 9, I'll just put it at 4.
Alright, you put it at 4? Got it. So, Roll to save your poise.
10.
10, oh boy. You get poise broken. Not only have you been taking damage from that, but now he has a chance to do his 10% type attack. He grabs you, but he then grabs upon your shoulder, comes around. You then hear a kshing, and then directly through your neck, his bone blade goes.
Sorry, my audio just went dead for a minute.
I'm going to enjoy controlling you.
He pulls out his blade. You failed the fight. But you did pretty well. You did pretty well, but your poise was like instantly broken after that hit. And that hit probably would have been fatal for you anyways.
Yeah.
You weren't fast enough to hit him with a crit, but then he literally punished you for trying to hit the crit.
Yeah, he literally pulled a Jiro.
No, many bosses will do that. You'll learn. There are bosses out there who will literally count guard counter. Which guard countering is, they block your attack, get a glint in their eye, go to a little ching, and then they literally counterattack. That's how guard counters work. It's a counterattack. So you got hit with the counter, your voice got broken, and then he hits you with a bone blade assassination.
Yep.
So he then awakens from his body exactly where everyone left off from the last time, where obviously Lyrical standing in the bathroom pondering what Jiro said. And then he has control of your body temporarily. However, this won't last long. So here's how
shut up, Octo.
Here's how this works. Every time you go to sleep, you will have to fight that fucker. In the game, every time you sleep, you have to fight that fucker. And if you die, he gains 5% control of your body. So right now he's at 5%. If you completely back out and literally get woken up, that's only 1% control over your body. However, every time you die, or every time you back out, you will learn something of the Death Flame. You have recently just learned...
my head on the table every time I do die.
You learned a new spell called Death Flame.
This is the start of it.
Death Flame, you can conjure up a green flame onto your hand, and you can throw it like a ball. Like a fireball, in a sense. You throw it like a fireball from your hands. And it will inflict burning death onto people.
Oh, God.
Yes, enough of these fireballs hitting somebody, they can literally burn to death. And their soul goes straight to hell. That's how burning death works.
Oh.
So you just gain a new spell. Write down Death Flame.
Alright, God.
Ah, there's my notebook. Also, Torio.
Yeah.
Like you said, I DM'd you the backstory, like you said. Obviously, you got it.
All right. Yeah, I got it. So let's head back then. Tor Sasson is now your resident in your head. Give him taxes to pay. All right. So let's get back to the interrogation. Back with Jiro. So let's restart the interrogation scene. So because I didn't have technically, you didn't have all your backstories. So, Octo, you ready? I can see Octo is not ready, so let's start with somebody else. Who wants to go first?
I'm done, so I guess I could go first.
Julian, alright. Let's go with you first. Julian. How you doing, my friend? Go ahead and sit in the chair. He then points to the chair across the table.
Okay. It's in it.
Alright, buddy. So, tell me about yourself. Tell me your story. Tell me your backstory. Tell me who you are. Because I would like to know. So, everybody here would like to know the real you, my friend.
Okay, so, it all started when I was a child.
Mm-hmm.
And I think it was around the age of 6. And around the age of 6, my father started getting more aggressive. And, well, let's just say he did some not very nice things. And that is one of the reasons why
I... Did he beat your mother into hospital? What? Did he beat your mother to hospitalization? He then cocks his one eyebrow up at you.
How would you know that, first of all?
Well, you won't know that for now. He then opens his jacket ever so slightly, looks down in it, and then closes it back. Now continue.
Well, as I was saying, the reason why I wear a long sleeve jacket like this is, you know, just to cover up some of the things he did. And if we continue after that, I think it was around age of 13 when I started to just, you know, fall in love with games. And I just really loved the, you know, the unique game worlds that some people could think of. And I just, like, really loved how they designed those games. You know, just inspired me.
And the kids at the school, they bullied you for that shit, didn't they?
Now, first of all, I don't know how you know this information, but it's kind of freaky.
I know this information because it's not any of your concern. He then smiles. A warm smile, but sort of creepy at the same time.
Octo, oh my god.
What did Octo say?
He said he got the Glock 19 and caused the school shooting.
I got a Glock and Mirari. 17 shots, no 38. Anyways.
And I guess I'm going to be completely transparent. I think he started around high school. Senior year, I think. I don't know. But, the bullying, as you somehow knew, got worse than I expected.
And so they made you strip, and they sexually abused you, didn't they?
Now, I swear to God, if you somehow magically read my past and interrupt me one more time, I don't even know...
What will you do?
I don't know
you're
what
very,
I'm going to do.
You're a very soft person on the inside. Though, that could change.
Shut up.
That could change because of me. What I do here is I make ultimates who, let's just say, used to be bullied a lot for the things that they like. I turn them to warriors. I turn them to gods. I make sure they never get bullied again. Instead, they have the ability to just... whatever they want, just beat the shit out of their own bullies. I know you're a soft, caring boy down under. And listen, here's my advice to you, Julian. Whatever horny personality that you have, whatever type of resolution that you're hiding behind, just so you can socialize with other people, that's not the real you. I know
you
it.
You gotta expose me like this.
Because... he then puts a hand on your shoulder, because you need help, my friend. And I'm here to help you, no matter what. I know your true side, and because of that, I can relate in a way. Because...
oh, you're trying to be like the ultimate therapist.
Let's just say, having half black and half white hair makes me look like a demon back in the day, and well... it didn't end well for myself, It didn't end well for them either. Then gives a, not a tooth smile, but a warmer smile. So, Julian, tell me who you really are. Okay, my friend?
Well, I don't want to act weird or weird or that. Just that, I mean, clearly, no one would like the real me.
Listen.
So,
you're not weird.
It's just better to hide.
You're not weird. You're just yourself. It's not good to hide. Because you never know. He then points his hands towards the other party members that are in the room. Who knows?
Hey, look, I'm not talking right to you, right?
These may be your friends. These may be the friends you may be looking for. Some people don't find their friends until they're very old. Older than time, maybe. Then he gives a wink. But that's besides the point. The point is, be with the people you know will care for you. And you're not being weird, and there's no such thing as being weird. Because if anything, I'm weirder than everybody here. And there's no denying that fact. Especially if you know my kids, you definitely will know that I'm the weirdest fuck here. Then gives a toothy smile. So, Julian, how do you feel right now?
Well, so don't mind my acting. I have practiced the art of cry talk.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay, go ahead.
Well, I just never had people say anything like that before.
That's because those people are the wrong people to be around. Okay. He then gets up from his chair, walks up next to you, and just gives you a hug. Okay, bud.
Let me just type something in chat.
Internal screams. By the way, you could smell his aroma, and his aroma smells like the best thing ever? Best thing you've ever smelled. The sexiest thing you've ever smelled. The worst thing you've ever smelled. And, of course, the weirdest thing you've ever smelled. All in one package. It smells like nostalgia. Oh my God. He smells like nostalgia. That's what he smells like.
He smells like nostalgia.
He's what nostalgia smells like. Exactly what I said. All those things combined make the smell of nostalgia.
I have a question for Faded.
Huh? Almost on it.
Do you want to be trauma buddies?
Yes! Slay! Slay,
bro,
trauma buddies!
We can be trauma buddies!
I guess I'll be
yes.
I'm just over here being the group clown because I want to make everyone smile.
Well, Julian, how are you going to respond to Jiro? He just asked if you were okay.
I think I'm feeling better now.
Trust me. You are going to feel a lot better, my friend. Okay?
Okay.
Now, he then lets go of you for a second, puts his fist on his waist, literally looks like that one Junko sprite for a second, with that smile and everything. He does a triumphant walk all the way over to his chair, sits down, puts his hands behind his head, kicks his feet up, and then asks you, "So, Julian, anything else you want to say before I have the others take a crack at it?"
Well, I didn't know that they were there.
Trust me, when you're talking to me, you won't know if anybody's there. A lot of the time.
I asked you earlier. Do you need a therapist?
Possibly.
We could try to find one here. Since like really everything is ultimate, including this fucking Big Mac. Apparently, his name is Jerry Michaels.
Now, Julian, anything else you want to say outside of that?
I would like to say, anyone heard this, don't get the wrong idea.
Please.
It's okay. We're all friends here. Besides, you ain't the weirdest person I've ever met. You want to know fucking weird?
What?
You want to know weird? There's this woman in the Dark Realm. She calls herself Raiden. And she's just... God, she's weird. She pulled a sword out of her tits. It can't get weirder than that. God damn. And then there's this other Raiden I know. And then there's this other Raiden that I know. And he's like a fucking half-cyborg.
I have a question. Can I go to the restroom?
Why, of course you can. Go on ahead. Actually, no, wait, never mind. Don't take the restroom down the hall. Take the restroom upstairs, please, because, some wonky shit's happening in there right now. Alright? Gives a big smile.
Oh, shit, no! I want to use the bathroom with the wonky shit happening.
Fuck you.
You walk out, okay, why don't I paint a picture for you then? You walk out, actually, you walk down the hallway, you go to that bathroom. You want to go to that bathroom or the upstairs bathroom? You know what, might as well, I'll humor you. I'll narrate this. Go ahead. Make a decision.
I want to go to the bathroom with the crazy shit happening.
Alright. Go into the bathroom. And you see Faded just fucking convulsing. Her eyes are completely green. And they're glowing. She's convulsing. She's crawling up the walls and on the roofs. She's barfing up blood into the toilets. Then she jumps down.
Bro, she hit the Zaza way too hard, dog.
She then jumps down, flushes the toilet, and exits. Literally flushes the toilet with her foot, exits the stall. Whistles for a second, washes her hands, and then goes back to being a spaz.
My honest reaction is, what the fuck?
She then twists her head all the way around, looking directly at Julian.
What the hell is happening?
An ancient tongue. She starts crawling on all fours, on her back, her head twisted around, and she starts speed crawling towards Julian.
Oh,
you made the wrong choice.
You made the wrong choice, Rossi.
Oh, flexible. I like it.
Faded turns into the girl from the ring.
She jumps towards Julian. She jumps towards Julian, then the door slams shut. And it's actually a Jiro with completely black hair and red eyes. With a completely forever smile, going like,
"That's the wrong choice! Head upstairs, my friend."
He then goes around the corner and just disappears.
What the hell did I just witness?
The weirdest shit you've ever seen!
Also, can I have a question why I went to supposedly the women's restroom?
Because it's a unisex restroom.
What? Oh my god, yes!
The year was 2047X.
There's literally a sign outside saying, if you're gonna have sex in this bathroom, clean up after yourself. Right outside the bathroom. Jiro knows that people will fuck in that bathroom.
If Faded or the Torn Assassin's just gonna jump on top of me like that, at least take some responsibility.
Someone just did. Yeah. Alright, who wants to go next with Backstory Lane?
Alright. I got a little something special to tell about this backstory, baby.
Alright, come on, sit down, my friend Avon. My cartoonish-looking friend.
Alright. So, you wanna know all about me, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Hello?
Yes.
Did it pick up?
Did I pick up? Hello, hello, hello. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can.
Oh, good, okay. I said, mm-hmm.
Oh. Wow. Aiden breaks out into musical time, baby. Here we go.
Oh, boy.
All right, let me tell you my story. Let me tell you about the legend of the Boxwood. This would have been really more fitting if there was music in here, but of course.
Oh, I hate to interrupt, but I just DM'd Toko, and they said they will not be making it.
Oh, that's unfortunate. Hold on, my friend. He looks like you... Hold on, my friend. He then gets up, twirls around. Looks like you need a bit of a jazz, don't you?
Yes.
Hold on. So let me give you a beat. Let me try to get you a beat, huh? Let's see. Is this good enough?
No. Actually, I had to make more money than this.
Nope, that's wrong. Hold on, wait. Yeah, this actually has a lot of, let's see, is this better?
Hold on, let me pull this up. Alright, I'm not sure if you can see it, but that's the one I'm talking. That's the one I need.
Which one?
Graze the Roof.
Huh?
Graze the Roof.
Which one? Tell it to me again, so I can get it.
Grazed the Roof.
Pleased the Roof.
No, Graze the Roof.
Graze the Roof. Alright, let me exit out of this real quick. Got it. Oh, there it is. There it is. Alright, there we go.
Alright.
He then pulls out... He then has a whole band apparate each different colors of himself. Go ahead, my friend. Swing it.
Baby face is exhausting.
Yes, we can hear you. My dog is talking. Okay, first off, outside of game, please record that. Please record that, because I really want to hear that song now. That actually sounded fantastic. But first off, I can hear the pixels. I can hear the pixels singing.
Yeah.
The high quality the music. The high quality music with the low quality singing killed me. And when Fluffy deafened, it killed me.
And while that was happening, I exit out of the activity and I'm just tuning my guitar.
Welcome
oh my
to
god.
Puerto
Rico. All right. Before I release this video, I want you to record you singing that with the audio. Octo, record that singing with a proper microphone, and guess what I'll do?
I don't have one.
I'll cut it, or just record it with a microphone. I will hold off this video until even next week, maybe. Until you get, like, if you record your voice, like, sing it again, record your voice, and... Oh god, that was hilarious. And I'll put the song, edit the song into the video. How about that?
Alright. God, I gotta start making lyrics. Shit.
So, everybody, if you're hearing this, this is post-edit. Basically, this is happens after the song's edited.
Oh, okay.
Should I just upload it? Just with that low quality shit.
If you want to, yeah.
I'll upload it and then edit it after you get the full song, because I can edit it. Alright.
Oh boy. Guess I gotta do music now.
So, Jiro's like, "Bravo, my friend, bravo!" And while you were doing that, you didn't notice, but Jiro just started using magic to play out your entire memories in front of everybody.
Oh. Oh.
So tell us in basic summary what happened in those memories.
Well, long story short, I was raised in a family. Well, obviously, as you know, some theatrics and all that stuff. At age 10, I performed for the first time. And it was a smashing success. Really, I can tell you that much. And then some blah, blah, blah shit. Falling out with creative differences with their family, porn addiction. You know, all the teenager stuff.
Mm-hmm.
After a while, my mom called me up and she's like, Hey, Avon, why do you want to travel the world? Let's start with Europe first. Yes, and that's where Avon's traveling circus began. It was not really a circus. It was more like, you know, theater.
Yeah, a theater, so. Yeah.
So, yeah, pretty much afterwards, that was it. I did the Americas where I performed now. Until this shit happened, and, well, you know. But as you could tell from my song, I kind of want to find love. The first girlfriend I had, whether I would really count her as a girlfriend, more like
a wife of sorts, someone to settle down and perform with you. Am I correct, my friend?
Oh yeah, pretty much. Also,
you're Minnie to your Mickey, basically.
Yeah.
Yes. Absolutely, I'd love that. And I'd love to help you out. Absolutely. He then gives that smile of, I'm gonna help you whether you like it or not smile.
Alright. Also, the theater life is good, but I want more in my life. I reached the goal of being a pretty good star. Now I want to be like my grandpa. Great hero. Seems my opportunity has come here now.
And yes, it is, my friend. And you will be trained to become a hero, to harness your inner ultimate abilities. Because you may be a theatrical performer, but, of course, I've assigned you under the guise of Ultimate Cartoon. Because not only does the cartoon perform in front of an audience, but the cartoon has powers beyond all comprehension. Even I don't understand how your abilities work.
Oh, you see, that's a thing called skill issue. I'm just kidding, my friend.
I don't possess that.
Damn. He could whoop my ass in Smash Bros.
I literally do not possess that. By the way, Jiro does not have that because he has the highest health pool in the game.
Yeah.
Wanna know how much his health is?
400,000, Warhammer 40k.
Nope. His health, Jiro Zadanti's total health, is 210 million.
Damn, bro got the bank.
Jesus Christ.
Bro got the dough on deck.
I mean, at least it's higher than a Torn Assassin's.
He has four phases. If you were to boss fight him.
Human, bear, dragon, monkey, dragon, Toriel Jackson.
Each of these phases are harder than the last, and if you boss fight him, you will die a lot. Because there was a player in DRU. A little DRU history lesson for you guys. A little bit more lore. There was a player in DRU who did fight him. It took him 116 tries to even get past his second phase. Took him 250 tries to completely defeat Jiro Tsunade.
Alright, damn.
He a fucker. Anyways, bravo, Aven! And by the way, did you know this? I knew all of that and more.
Well, judging from the Frosty interview, which I just stand there, I have been eating some flan. Yeah, pretty much.
I like you, my friend. I believe you and I are going to get along just fine.
Yep.
Anyways, so, who is next up on the chopping block?
Let's see here.
Who wants to be next? For backstory time.
Who wants to meet therapist Jiro?
So, yeah. Fluffy. So, Rogers. You want to come on
yes.
up?
Yes.
All right. You
yes,
up?
I'll go.
All right. So, Rogers, please sit down. Jiro sits back down. So, you're a big man, I see. Go ahead.
Yes.
Tell me your story, O brave knight of the Novoselic family.
All right, I'll tell you my story. I once was a brave knight. The bravest, some may call me. I was chosen as number one in the Royal Guard. That's how I got my title, as the ultimate knight. Lots of people liked me, the townspeople as well as the royal Novoselic family. My main duty was to protect the family, mainly the Princess Sonia Nevermind. She was a nice girl, but she refused protection from me. I taught her a lot of fighting techniques instead, so she could at least protect herself. I wasn't always the knight I am today. I was abandoned as a child. My parents both lost their lives when I was just 7 years old. Well, it was a tragic fire. But I was only seven, so
I
don't remember much.
I understand. Please continue.
I had to fend for myself until I was 11. I lived in the streets of the town, stealing bread from the local bakery. Once, an old nice man who lived in a took me in. He had just moved there. He was like a father to me.
He was a blacksmith, correct?
Yes. But he was also a swordsmith. But the town, he was more popular for his blacksmith.
Hold on.
He taught me many skills.
What did he look like? What does he look like?
Well, he used to be a nice young man. He would always wear a blue dress shirt and a hat.
A hat? What type of hat is this? Like, is it a cap?
He would wear a top hat.
A top hat? A top hat?
Yes.
Did it have a crest on it, like the Novoselic royal crest, or maybe a Nordic crest, so and say?
I think it might have. Although,
was his
he
name,
doesn't really wear a hat anymore.
Was his name, perchance, Gungnir?
Yes.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Well. Well, well, well. No wonder you're so much of a Giga Chad. You're a good years boy. I should have known. he's right outside. His forge is just beyond the parking lot.
Really?
He's here, yeah. He makes the ultimate weapons for everybody here. He's a forger chosen by the Nordic god Thor.
Oh, I'd love to see him again.
And that
it's been
you will.
Quite a while.
And that you will at one point. But anyways, let us continue. Let us continue. So, he was your hero, correct?
Yes, I wanted to be just like him. And that's why I became a knight.
You grew stronger
so I could...
for every battle. And you were accepted, and you were approved and accepted by your father.
He was quite proud of me. I wanted to bring joy to all the children who I once was like.
And you had someone dear to you, did you?
Yes. My lover.
What happened to her? Was she severely injured in a battle?
Yes. Legs were destroyed.
Legs were destroyed.
They live at home now. They were retired from being a knight after that incident.
Do you have a name?
I do not want to name them. The name is special to me.
I'm so sorry, Rogers, but... Well... Nova Selic has been taken... by... Nova Selic has been taken by Lord Orda the Conqueror. And Sonya has plans to take it back. She's forging a force of ultimates to go after her home once again. If you wish to join her, I will not stop you.
That girl was destined for greatness.
She was.
She was something special.
She was not only your lover, correct? She was more than just that. She was a wife. Am I correct?
Sure. Actually, no. She was like, she was... I taught her many things, but we were never romantically involved.
But she was your lover. She had to have a name. But that name is... Is that name, by any chance, Celestia? Judging by your silence, I'm either right or wrong.
I'll let you figure that one out.
Well, there has been rumors of a robotic-legged vigilante woman who calls herself Celestia. She's a hero of Nova Selic. And she has been going around saving innocent lives and making sure they avoid Lord Orda's wrath. Does that sound
Sounds
familiar?
Intriguing.
To you? Does that sound familiar to you?
Somewhat familiar.
Well, if you do end up If you do ever end up meeting Celestia, or run into her while you are in Nova Selic, do let me know if she is the right woman. He then gives a half smile.
All right, I'll let you know.
Thank you very much, my friend. So, anyone else on the chopping block for today? Well,
hold on. Roger had sex with Celeste.
No, Celestia. Celeste is someone else. Celestia.
This also goes by Celestia.
There could be more than one Celestia.
Oh my god.
Yes, there can be more than one Celestia. It's a common Celestia name.
Ancient Impact Mata. Reference?
Not that Celestia. She's a completely original
Celestia. Genshin Celestia, yes, Slay.
It's in a completely original Celestia. Anyways, Ryo, would you please take a seat? He goes back to his usual slacking position, smile on his face, hands behind his head, and of course, kicking his legs up on the table and leaning his chair back.
I don't know why the hell I'm doing this. What's any good to know about me?
What's there any good to know about you? Well, my friend, my good friend.
Not your friend.
Your name is Ryo Kitsuaka. You are the ultimate shrine maid. You are also known to be a servant of eternity and the leader of justice and purity. You appear to be completely human, correct? But no, truth be told,
how the hell do you know all of that?
You're a kitsune from a different world. A world that a certain someone in Japan currently is in that she doesn't belong to. You have abilities such as controlling water. You're about 5 years old. You gained your titles. But about the same age, you and your twin brother. What's his name again? Basically? You're kidnapped by humans and brought to the human world. This world. For experimentation. You and your brother were pumped full of drugs and all sorts of things. And, well, it shortened your lifespan to only about 35 years. But that has changed because the side effects of the DRU extends your lifespan to about 265 years. And that goes for all of you, by the way. Ultimate Ethereum Resurrection Advice, the UARD, one of them is extension life, which means you lived up to 265 years old.
Copyright hasn't taken me yet, so I'm okay.
Probably not. You did manage to escape, however, Ryo. After 10 years of suffering from experiments, and this is why one of your trigger words is labs, shots, drugs, and all sorts of different things, you've had enough, and you went to hunt down every single scientist from the lab, and you blew that bitch sky high.
How do you know all that?
It's not about me knowing. It's about the trauma you hold on your shoulders. Because of this trauma, you've become cold, cruel, ignorant, completely disrespectful. Though your intelligence strength and your wits, they grew day by day. You got a job later with your brother, and you eventually both got a house together. You started at Ten Hopes Peak Academy, well, because of your exceptional talents, as an ultimate, of course. Eventually you found your way back to your actual home. But basically wanted to stay in the human world. You were disgusted by him. And you returned home. You left him behind. Left him to be taken by the queen of your world. You left him. And you went home. Out of your own self-pity And your trauma just kept on pressuring you and just made you into someone who was cold and heartless in you. Well, here's advice I could give to you. Let's see. I think these are some of your exact words. Correct me if I'm wrong, Rio. Not a pip, not a sound, not a tear left to shed. Why do they keep doing this to us? Haven't we suffered enough? Get out of my head. That was something you said when you were young, naive, an absolute idiot. You're not the same now. Drugs pumped into your body, blood taken, bone marrow extracted. Life was a living hell. You thought, for the longest time, you were nothing more than a lab rat. From 5 to 15, 10 solid years. All realization sank, and you're 16. You became, went from kind, you let the trauma take over your entire world and your entire personality. Here you are, right now. Unchanging,
shut up.
Unmoving. What of it? Was it worth it? Was it worth all the kitsune you had to sacrifice, who were also tested in that lab? You burned the lab with them inside, and you knew they were in there. You just decided to leave. Leave as it was blowing, try to blow your world sky high, make sure you never came back. That's why you left your brother behind. You didn't want any evidence of that world, did you now? You did not want to be a kitsune. No. You hated being that.
What are you going to say next? You know what's actually under my hair? What my eye actually looks like under my hair? Is that what you're going to say next?
Yes. Exactly. But I'll save that. Because I'm pretty sure these fine fellows would love to find that out. Listen, I want to give you some advice. Rio, do you want to know why you are the way you are? I just said it a million different times. You let your trauma chain you. Chain you. Make you its bitch. You let your trauma consume you and change you. Made you someone you weren't supposed to be. You think you've endured for long enough. You don't know suffering. You have no idea what I've been through. You have no idea what I've sacrificed to get everything you see here. Their armor. The alliance of two secret armies who've been killing each other for years. Me bringing together humanity under one flag. The risk that I had to take, took sacrifice, and put a barren toll onto my fucking soul. But did I let all those negativities consume me? No. Because truth be told, I've been through a lot worse. And for a time, I did let it consume me. Back in my old days, when I was just blindly killing people on the street for the fun of it. But I realized my actions had severe consequences not only my mental health, of course, my psyche, on my social status, on my, basically me, as a whole. You may think you suffered for 10 years. Imagine suffering from the day you were born to now. I was born. Want to know how old I am? I was born in 1922. When were you born, Rio? Answer me. He then gives you that cold stare. That authoritative stare.
Go on, Rio.
What year I was born?
Yes. Tell me.
2051.
Yeah. I was born in 1922. I'm over 100. I've been through shit. Rio just... Or probably basically went to do some stuff. So, my friends.
I have several questions.
Yes?
What? Do you guys need therapy?
All of you have problems you need to solve yourselves. Throughout your journey here, you'll eventually get to...
I did solve my important addiction by not just watching it. But holy fuck! You'll need some therapy, you'll need some anxiety.
All of you have troubles. You are still growing, my friend. All of you are still growing. Some of you need to grow out of your past traumas. And some of you have just started your growth and are beginning to grow even more into a massive flower. You will bloom. And when you bloom from a flower to a grand tree, you'll know. You'll know true hope. You'll know true hope. And relinquish and destroy all despair that you've had before. Alright! And he crosses his hand together. Alright, I think that is about time. It is around 7:30. It's around 7:30. You guys need to get back to Ultimate District to your rooms. And you need to go to sleep. Because 8 o'clock is curfew.
What the fuck? I come that way. You know what? Alright. You do realize that without the darkness, there will be no light, and vice versa. Now, personally, I understand where you're coming from. Don't get me wrong. Life can be a bitch sometimes. But I think it's more important that life could be a bitch. That way we learn mistakes and bring light into our life. However, we should also accept the darkness in our life as well. Do you understand what I'm trying to say?
Yeah. I understand, my friend. He's pushing everyone out the door. Alright, you guys need to get back before 8 o'clock. Or else, well... everything will go to hell. Or, really, you're not supposed to stay past bedtime curfew. You need around 8 hours of sleep, of course, and I'm giving you more. We go to sleep at 8 o'clock, and... Well, actually, tonight you go to sleep at 8 o'clock. Wait, no, wait. What's the... Excuse me, my friends. How do you, what is the time schedule I set up again today?
My emperor, you set your time. You said the time for sleep is 10 o'clock, but Ultimate District closes at 8 p.m.
Right. The gates close at 8 p.m., so you guys gotta skedaddle. Everyone's out in the hallway right now. Faded walks out in the hallway. Well. She is indeed herself again.
Avon lines up and hugs her.
Hi.
Hi.
Hello, Faded. Hello, Faded. Hey, hello, Faded. Were you shitting up demons in that toilet? Or were you shitted on by a demon? I humor myself. Shit jokes are awesome.
Fuck you, Jiro.
You wish you would. Anyways, everybody get... Alright, everybody.
Normally, that would be my cue to jump in and make a joke, but I'm stopping myself this time.
Of course.
Self-control.
Alright.
Hops on fucking Fade's back. Like, a fucking piggyback. It's like, I want my friend... to the Netherlands!
So, wait, what's happening now, exactly?
We're going to sleep?
We're going to the Ultimate District. It closes at 8 p.m., so we gotta hurry up. Immediate.
Oh, God, are you kidding me?
All right, you guys. Jiro then pulls out a shotgun. All right, you got 10 seconds before I air this bitch out. 10, 9, 8, 7.
I just casually take my time walking.
Then, 6.
I grab Fade's arm and just book it.
Hey!
We gotta go!
What happens if I just stand still?
Jiro will shoot and kill you.
Oh. Wait, so if I die, am I gonna, like, change all my clothes again?
Yes.
Yes. You will respawn the lab. He will kill you.
Stand still.
If he says something, he'll do still. It. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. A demon dog then picks Julian up and then throws him at the door before it closes.
A demon dog can go murder itself.
You exit through the door just in time. Just in time, as he starts shooting shotgun shells through the air inside the building. You can barely hear the boom, 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 boom coming from inside.
Guys, sorry to have main character syndrome over here, but we gotta skedaddle!
You see the shells then go through the roof as you guys are running to the troop transport as soldiers are coming, are literally telling you guys to get on. Come on, let's go!
I'm throwing every single member in there. I throw every single member of our party into the van.
Alright, everyone.
You can't throw me.
Yeah, you can't throw Rogers, but Rogers just gets in. He just gets in.
Burn the brakes!
So, then they...
I'll even just close them now.
They then start booking it from the military district. You guys start driving. Driving towards the Ultimate District. There is one thing you do see. Red fog.
Okay. Guys? I think we're fucked.
Great, if you didn't let me take my sweet time, this wouldn't have happened, so thanks a lot.
What are you blaming me for, Mom? I mean, Faded.
Whatever.
Seems we have an unfamiliar coloration of fog. So...
Why don't we just drive straight through it and get into a car crash? That'd be lovely.
So, you've come to kill yourselves again. You hear an echoing voice from above.
And...
Oh, God damn it.
Not again.
This is the sixth boss fight Faded has been in.
Okay, wait, hold on. Let me bang my head on my desk real quick. There we go. Ow, that actually hurt.
Hey, look, we just went out of trouble, right? Can we just pass then, through?
Then, a bolt of light, hold on. Then, all of a sudden, you hear this. You hear this hit the front of the truck. The truck then flies, and it literally comes on top of itself. It's upside down. Shadow rains then kick down the doors. Ultimates, get down! They start shooting at Reptile the King. Reptile the King obviously gets hit by these bullets, but is unfazed. Then pulls up his Barrett and kills both of them with one shot. Upon that one shot, they explode into gold dust. Both of them.
My computer's about to die.
Go and plug it in.
No, it's because I haven't charged it since.
Okay, I kind of just want to hop out and just kind of walk and just.
You can't do that.
Don't mind me, sir.
I look up and say, go on then, boy, we're not the chosen one yet. We're not chosen ones. The chosen ones are...
Everyone exits the vehicle.
The girl who lives.
I want it. I just want it.
Boss fight time. Welcome back, bitches.
I was just in one not even an hour ago. Come on.
Suffer.
Oh, I just realized I'm unmuted.
My phone's about to fucking die.
Alright, so who's going first?
I
might as well take the risk.
Hey, what are we doing?
I guess I'll go after
Fate. We're fighting the evil gold guy.
Wait, boss fight?
Yep.
Wait, everyone?
Yep.
Last
everyone
time we
here.
Died.
Wait. Okay. Oh, okay.
Does he still have a quarter of health left?
No. He's back to heal to full.
No!
I'm actually mad.
So wait, have we decided who's going first?
But then, all of a sudden, you then hear a motorcycle revving. Mondo pulls up. With Taka and Chihiro. Chihiro comes over the back with a Spaz 12 and starts airing out that hoe.
I look at Taka and I point at him and say, hey, you're the gay guy.
I'm not gay, okay?
Let the man I tell Fader, shut up and let them cook.
So Chihiro empties 6 shells into this fuck. Takes about a quarter of his health in those 6 shells. He then gets poise broken. Ishimaru jumps from the bike, lands on him, and then starts stabbing him with a flurry, stabbing him with a knife in the neck, taking him down to half.
Faded just in the background, pulling out a bucket of popcorn and starts eating, enjoying the show.
I pull out my Glock and start shooting at the bitch.
Mondo then brings a chain and wraps it around the legs of Reptile, and then starts driving away towards the danger zone. You will not hear the last of me, Ultimates. You shall never walk the path that I once took. He then disappears, and the boss fight theme and the health goes away.
Aw, it's not even an hour-long movie. It was just like 5 minutes.
Shut the fuck up. If you
You do not want to know what happened last fight.
We got.
Oh, please, don't worry. You don't know what I've been through.
Obviously, you don't have your script.
Aven then notices there's a jade kunai on where your kunai belt sleeve is. One sticking out.
Ooh. Ooh! That is pretty faint. Wait a minute, that's yours, isn't it?
It's on her chest, dude.
I
have more. Wait, no. What do you mean? You just seen things.
Faye's eyes, as she says that, go into a bright green.
Uh-huh. Hey, guys, I think Fate is broken.
The gates have opened. Are you okay? Are you okay, my friends? We heard there was trouble out here. We knew you guys were coming back.
So, we all decided that, the 3 of us decided that we would make sure you guys got back home safely.
I have no idea who that guy was, but he kept on talking about following in his footsteps. What in the hell does that mean?
Wait.
I'm gonna be for real with you.
His footsteps? Did he say who?
Well, he was mentioning himself. That golden... What did Mondo call him again?
I think he called him Casper the Unfriendly Piss.
I love that name!
Oh, okay. Luckily, it's not him.
Who is him you are referring to?
Nothing. You shouldn't be bothered about it. trying to stuff the jade kunai in my pocket.
All of you then start hearing this. Every one of you. What's that sound?
I think it sounds like a ticking clock.
No. You guys gotta head back now.
Well, we're gonna listen to her. Come on, let's move. Away, back to Ultimate District.
Do we take her?
Take her?
Yeah.
Of course, she's one of you, isn't she?
Oh, yeah. Wait, yeah, I'm just making sure. I grab Faye's arm and drag her.
I told you for the last goddamn time, you little cartoon piece of shit. Put me down.
Look, Faye. Jesus Christ, Aiden. Stop. Faye. Be careful, alright? I don't know what is going on. But there's something definitely wrong.
Her eyes are getting greener by the second.
I told you for the last time, I'm fine. Now go!
Bitch. I can see the fucking eye. Clearly you're in a race with some weird
cop. I don't care. Go. Now.
What if I don't?
I grab Aiden's arm, shove it off me, and then shove him out of my way.
Upon shoving him, Faden shoving him, Aiden goes flying, and Faden accidentally gives him a little death flame. On his body, he feels an intense heat as he's gifted 15% burning death. He goes flying to a tree and hits the tree.
God. Slade.
Hey, what's the fire on me?
Your eyes then fade from green back to their normal color, fading. Machimi has stopped.
Oh, God.
Okay, so question, where's the fire?
The fire has dissipated at this point. It was on your clothes, but it's no longer there.
Do I have
I run up to Aiden and I kneel down towards him. Look, I'm sorry, I didn't...
Aiden looks up, and through his eyes, you don't see it faded. But he looks up and sees this horrifying, yellow-eyed, creepy-looking motherfucker that's like 7 feet tall, right above your shoulder, Faden. You know who I'm talking about.
God damn it.
Hey, so about the rape comment, Simon, is that the guy who raped you? As I point toward the digger.
What do you mean?
Do you not see him?
What? Aiden then blinks and he's gone. Completely.
I don't know who you're talking about.
Alright, so I got three things. Either A, I just tripped balls after the fire on my clothes. B, I just experienced hallucinations after that giant hit. Or C, somebody has a fucking stand and I'm a stand user. Okay, who has a stand? Raise your hand.
Nobody raise your hand.
Look, we need to get back before it's too late. I grab Aiden's arm and then just start running back.
Rogers and Jillian just shrug. Huh? Well, follow me! I know the way back! You guys realize you're like literally you guys are literally 2 feet from the gate. Well, the gate's right there, never mind.
Okay, whatever you say, gay man.
I am not gay!
I was going to say that. How dare you?
I'm going to keep on talk of that.
No one realized I'm back. How lovely.
I know. Yeah. So let me tell you what you just witnessed, Rio. So, Jira ended ended interrogations. He was about to air the bitch out. You guys left, got on the troop transport. Boss fight was about to happen with Casper the Unfriendly Piss. And then Mondo, Chihiro, and then and Ishimaru came in to save the day. Mondo chained that fucker from the legs and drove him away, making sure that the way was clear for you guys to get into Ultimate District before the time ran out. So Mondo's now somewhere in the danger zone, dragging Casper the Unfriendly Piss.
Faded
ended up, everybody started hearing clocks, and like everyone started hearing clocks. And Rio, whatever Avon was seeing, whenever at this point she's like, at this point it's after the fact where Faded has grabbed Avon's arm and is running over to where the gates are, trying to get into the Ultimate District along with everybody else. While she was knelt down, Avon was seeing the torn assassin. You saw that fucker too, standing right behind Faded. Both of you saw that fucker.
Okay, my character turned towards Rio and then just yells at her. Come on, we have to go!
Alright.
Wait, Faded, can I at least hop on your back? Damn.
Well, too bad, so sad. This is how it's like being dragged, and you're gonna keep being dragged.
Okay, fair point. I hop. I let go. I break her grip and hop on her back.
God, you were light as a feather.
I know. I don't eat. I have a good diet.
Anyways, everybody runs into Ultimate District, and the gate closes behind them. What about Mondo? Mondo will be fine. Trust me. I know him. He's gonna be driving that bike all night like he did like he did three times already.
But what about the dragon?
There's a fucking dragon?
Over in the danger zone. He's been spotting some dragons.
What was this?
With his driving skills, I'm sure he'll be fine.
Wait, dragon? Can we capture one? Tame it?
No, we are not taming a dragon.
That sounds like a good idea.
Dragon.
That also
Oh my god, wait. So is it like How to Train a Dragon?
Yes.
No! What do you look like?
Can I tame, what's it called? Oh, what's the dragon called?
Okay,
I'm getting toothless.
Okay, so, remember when I said any creature can be tamed? You can tame this dragon, but he's also a boss fight. So you gotta get him to very low before you can possibly tame him. Or you can kill it, get its dragon heart, go to a dragon temple, and get yourself some dragon magic.
Alright.
Listen, we are not taming a dragon.
Alright. Anyways, all of us should head over to the Golden Mansion. I think it's about time that we settle you guys down, and everybody have a nice sleep tonight.
Alright, Ishimaru, I'll take it from here. You sound so boring and edgy.
And gay.
You are gay.
Thank you. You agree with me. I like you.
Thank you.
It's Kokichi. It's Kokichi.
Guys, I can confirm that he is gay because I caught him and Mondo making out.
For the last time, I'm not gay!
Just stop denying it. I'm gayer than you, though. I'm a femboy.
As Chihiro walks off.
Anyway.
I have a plan.
I'm not really too bothered going to rest, you know? I need to practice a little bit.
Oh no, Missy. You gotta go to your bedroom. If you don't, well, Mr. Jiro's gonna be very mad. And, like myself, I don't want to make Mr. Jiro mad. Last time I did, which was like 2 days ago, and also this morning, he punted me like a football all the way over to the danger zone. And then I had to fight a dragon. It was fun.
I'm definitely going to get in trouble every single night because I have insomnia.
Oh, you have insomnia? Oh, yes, don't worry. Oh, don't worry. I can fix that. Kokichi just whacks his pistols in the back of your head and knocks Fade it out. Alright, everyone to their rooms. Grab.
Wait, if I'm knocked out, do I have to fight him again?
You do have to fight him again.
God. He had insomnia.
Please, no. I don't want to fight him again. I don't want to go through that torture. I don't
think of insomnia. Any regrets?
Kokichi starts dragging Faded by her legs. All right, everyone to their rooms. Follow me.
We got room key.
I really don't want to fight him.
You just jump off the arena.
I kind of want to do that now. I kind of want to do that. I don't care anything.
All right. Final destination melee brawl. No items.
So you guys get to the lobby. You guys get to the lobby of the Golden Mansion after passing the wondrous gardens, though you cannot see its full beauty in the nighttime. But it does look kind of creepy, though. The Golden Mansion, though, with the lights beaming on the Golden Mansion, make it shimmer in the night sky. Like stars. It's beautiful. It's a beauty beholded as one of the 8 wonders of the world. As you get inside the lobby, it looks a lot like a hotel lobby. Then you see someone familiar standing at the front lobby desk. Hello there! My name's Nagito Komaida. How may I check you in today? Nagito! I'm trying to get them to the room.
Oh, God, it's Nagito!
What the fuck?
Faded!
I walk up to Nagito.
Faded!
Can you have,
go ahead.
Hi, sir. Can we have, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's currently 5 of us, right, guys?
Yes, idiot.
Oh, wait! You're the new Ultimates, aren't you? My father told me all about you. You guys fill me with such hope as beacons of the future.
Wait, isn't his father?
Yes.
Oh, I have a restraining order.
Yes. Shiro Sadachi is my biological father. Turns out I was actually adopted by the Komaida family. I didn't know that until Jiro showed evidence of my birth certificate.
God,
I am filing.
That's kind of disappointing.
Wait, so his real name is Nagito Sadanchi?
Yes, his real name is Nagito Sadanchi.
Nagito Sadanchi, more like Nagito Wanchi.
Anyways, here are the keys to all your rooms. I hope you have a hope-filled night.
You too, random person. That made me uncomfortable.
Oh. All of a sudden...
Just pee in my unconscious hand.
So, you want to know how much... you want to know how overpowered Nagito's luck is in this game? Ready?
Over 9,000.
Faded wakes up in the jaded arena.
Oh, god damn it.
Wait, I have a solution for Faded.
First off, let me say this. Let me narrate it. Let me cook.
Just file a restraining order on the Tori assassin.
Ah, yes, that will work from a dead spirit that nobody else can see.
Would, obviously.
Alright, so let me cook. Faded gets up. There's a empty soda can all of a sudden laying perfectly down. She gets up, slips on it, and falls off the arena.
I prepared a melee rule set, bro. What the fuck?
Before, of course, they get up to the stairs where Kokichi's like, by the way, I'm gonna drag her all the way up these stairs. Why? Because, well, I'm Kokichi Oma.
Oh, God, I swear, if every time I hit a stair with my head and I knock out and I slip out of the arena, he's gonna 100% taken my body by the time.
By the way, as he fell out of the arena, you heard this, by the way.
That was
oddly easy. You then wake up just before Kokichi was gonna drag you up the stairs, and you get up.
You do not do that, because if you did, it would have turned out horribly.
Well, just my luck. Just before she got absolutely wrecked by the torn assassin.
Wait, how the fuck?
Wait a minute. Hold
on. Do not question my methods, because guess what? I don't even fucking know either. Anyways, hold on.
He then pulls out the same, from his coat, the same exact stopwatch that Jiro keeps in his coat.
Well, looks like we're just an... Actually, I think we're a bit early this time. Or, no, wait, hold on. Oh yeah, we are just in time. So everybody head up to your rooms and get a good night's sleep. And something tells me, Faded, that he won't be bothering you tonight. Not on my watch.
Uh-huh.
Okay, whatever. Can I get some coffee, actually, before I go upstairs?
Don't worry, I've already prepared several lines of cocaine-filled coffee upstairs in your room.
Oh, thank God. I'd love that. Thank you.
You're very welcome. Also, as all of you are looking at me very confused, my goals are beyond your understanding.
Then he just walks away.
Faded's not there anymore. She's just rushing up the stairs.
Do I put a restraining order on that man?
Nope.
Now I think he's a profile.
No. He's fine. He's more like his father now. Anyways, come on, let's go up the stairs. Ashley.
All right, that's
good. Aiden, want to race?
I want to.
How many flights of stairs?
Come on, ready? Last one up the stairs is a rotten egg.
I'm already up here.
Children.
All right, make ready for a speed check.
Yeah, my speed is 9, so I think I'm okay.
All right. 3, 2, 1, go. You start running up the stairs. You are faster than Kokichi, obviously. You are running up the set of stairs, and eventually you get to the floor you're supposed to be on. But Kokichi is already up there. You just saw him behind you.
Good race, you two. I pat Avon on the back. Try harder next time, buddy.
Okay.
Faded. What you saw... You saw him apparate up the stairs. In a purple flash.
You know, Kokichi. Even though I kind of hate you, you're a pretty cool guy.
Thanks. You remind me of Makiro. Call me that again. I'll
fucking
kill
you. Of course. Everyone says I'm a fucking Maki clone.
Well, it's kind of true. Since technically you are, then all of a sudden his mouth shuts.
Good night, and I will see you in the morning, bitch. Wait.
Children these days, dear God.
Everybody, go ahead.
I look at Kokichi. I go, you better teach me some goddamn.
How the fuck you managed to do that shit?
It's a secret.
Okay, I quickly enter my dorm and then slam the door and lock it.
Alright. Hey, Kokichi, I got a good plan for tomorrow, early in the morning.
Well, I'm sorry, but you... Well, actually, never mind. Of course I'd love to! Can't wait.
If it's about me, I swear to God.
No. It's for everyone. Alright, so, at 6 a.m. in the morning, 6:30, we wake up early. Don't sneak in.
We talked about this on the last podcast. I remember.
Mm-hmm. Here's some pack.
I remember.
I want Jiro to come try and join us, along with another guy. His name is Frosty. He's important later on the story.
Hey, Julian.
But that's not important right now. We clang the pants while we think Suavemente. I can give you lyrics if I pull out the fucking lyrics.
Oh, I know Suavemente.
Good. Let's make it more easier. Alright, so, remember the plan. Operation Loudre.
Alright, I'll go make sure Jiro knows. And then he just walks to the end of the hallway and just disappears.
Look. Oh my god, Jason. Alright, what's my dorm room?
You see, your door, actually, each of your doors are very unique to your very personality. They're all designed in a certain way, depending on your character. Let's start with, basically, Ryo's door is that replicant of a shrine door.
Did Faded just play the guitar?
Faded got the guitar.
Faded got the guitar.
Faded got the guitar.
Faded. Whenever the whenever a musical time comes, I'll let you know, so that way we can make a song.
I don't play guitar. I just got it for Christmas, okay?
Oh, you're learning.
I'm trying to get lessons, but I'm broke as a joke, so I can't get any.
Just you get them. Just get Simply Guitar.
Simply Guitar.
Or musicians, so you can learn Metallica songs.
I mean, Metallica's not really my style anymore. I like Russian metal now. Like Russian that metal? Type. Yeah.
You still Russian gotta, metal. Come on, you gotta like Sabaton too, right?
Nah.
Bro, I'm more into the fucking video game soundtracks. Fucking, I'm hanging on to
another one. Anyways. Really like is the one.
Let me narrate your guys' doors. So, starting with basically, Ryo's door is that of a shrine door. It looks like that of, you know, a shrine. And, or a door that would lead to a shrine. And, of course, her picture is drawn like a traditional Japanese-style head photo. You know, the photos, or the pictures mm-hmm. on the front of doors in Danganronpa. Yours is drawn Yours is drawn half, like a half-human, the half-human version of you, and apparently, for some reason, also has your half-fox form on the other half of your body.
Okay.
I really
you enter your room. Ryo enters her room, and it's reminiscent that of her old room. Also, with an added touch of course, that shrine. That whole shrine maiden gimmick.
Alright.
Okay.
Next up with Julian, or Frosty. Julian's is that remnant actually looks like a God of War door. Just for another a video game reference. Into Julian's room. Inside of Julian's room is everything video game related, but most of it is fucking Genshin Impact and Super Smash Bros.
Even the original Nintendo?
Yes. By the way, also, there's a flat screen TV with every single video game console in existence inside Julian's room.
Even the original Nintendo! Fuck you!
Yo, Julian, you wanna play God of War, right?
I have that.
Yo, Julian,
Fluffy, what you've got on your door, it looks like doors to a royal palace of Nova Selic. As you enter, it is exactly replicate of your knight's chambers when you were serving as a knight.
Oh.
For good old Octo, good old Aven, it is a door that looks exactly like it came out of, you know, Steamboat Willie. Like the old black and white looking cartoon door.
You enter the room,
and everything is black and white. The door behind you disappears. Everything, then, it's a static. Hello, my wonderful friend Aven. You then see a man just appear in front of you, right in front of your face. I'm gonna give you what this man looks like. Ready? I'm sending you an image of what he looks like.
I swear to God. If it's him...
This is what he looks like. Hello, my wonderful friend.
Why do you look like that guy from the political cartoons I always scroll off?
Well, I'm exactly him. I'm Mr. Freeman. So nice to meet you, finally, Avon! It's been so long! Welcome
this
to
you. This is a revolt you expect. You should probably start working on something else. You look like a horror icon. I recommend you work on a horror play. Like a horror movie. That would be really incredible. What do you think, sir?
Oh, I'm worse than a horror movie. I'm beyond your own comprehension. I'm more than just a political cartoon. In your world, I am more! They hung me on a cross there in the old BC days, and also in the ADs before the Roman Empires! And yet I am here, standing before you, my friend. Here to be your guide, and also to weave your room to whichever you wish it for. Did you see me, Avon? You saw me, along with the rest of everyone. When you've died, when all of you died, you heard me. You see me. You see my voice now. You can feel me! Can you feel me now, Avon?
Sir? Sir, I am literally a cartoon character. Can I? Alright, hold on. I'm in my room, right?
Yes, you're in your room. It's a black, it's a completely white space now. All that's inside your room is you and this guy.
I tear down the piece of wallpaper to show me the player face. Sam, what the fuck is that shit? Dude, I'm gonna be for real with you. I'm not in real at all with this. Just get the ultimate perfect. Teach him back.
So this must be your player. Is he not? He looks yes. Kind of like a grandmother.
God damn. Damn, Tori, is that what you actually think of me, bro?
Maybe.
Yeah, bro, okay.
Jeez. Anyways, what? Go ahead. Anyways.
So, I'm at your service, Mr. Avon. Well, how would you like your room? Go ahead, describe it to me. Pop into my face! And I'll form it for you.
Okay, hold on. Sammy, do you have any ideas? Motherfucker, I'm not involved with the story. Do you have any ideas, yes or no? I can force DM to let this slide. I have a job! Even points a gun at my face. It's... Now. I am, motherfucker, I don't know, a balcony showing Pandora from James Cameron's Avatar.
He then pulls out a paintbrush from behind him.
You see, you should know this, Avon, that art is a form of expression. As expression and art and the imagination come together, collide in one fell swoop.
He sweeps the brush and it's exactly what you asked for.
All right, cool. This is very nice. What else?
Therapy for Faded.
I'm sorry, what?
No.
Therapist for Faded? Wait, what?
So.
Maybe.
Anything else for you?
Family?
Family?
Alright, this is the last time. You owe me, like,
$80. Do you wish for family?
Hell fucking no, we don't. You. I'll picture Coco, my girlfriend. Why? It'll be relevant later.
Oh, I see. So, Mr. Freeman makes a bed. A heart bed with Coco on it. Of course, giving you those eyes.
Does this tickle your fancy, sir?
I mean like a portrait.
Like a heart shape, yes. Rose petals and everything.
Yes, a portrait.
A heart shape. On my bed.
Heart. Okay. No, scratch that. Fuck you, autistic. You goddamn retard. Bro, you have the same conditions as me. No, I don't. I'm literally straight. You're bisexual. You have no rights.
Oh, you wish for an autistic man, don't you?
You know what, Amy? Nope.
You know what, Aiden? Fuck you. Can you place that bed with a... if I could just pull this up real quick.
Excuse me? What? Oh, I have an idea. An idea that may tickle your fancy if you wish for me to form it into your room.
Sure, I guess. Yeah, go for it.
He then forms your room. Abracadabra, welcome to the zoo! And then he jumps up, explodes into a firework, and Mr. Freeman disappears. But your room has been turned into a glorified version of your old stage.
This is really interesting. The only problem is, where the fuck am I gonna sleep?
You then see a bed. A bed that belongs to a king.
A what? Oh, shit. I see what you're talking about now.
Mm-hmm.
Tutorial. Hold on. Where's the wallpaper for the tutorial Discord icon? I think it's on the left side. All right, hold on. Aiden tears down the wallpaper to show Tutorial. Hey, thanks, Tutorial.
You're very welcome, Aiden. Also, I did not give you that perk yet. Oh, wait, that's right. The wallpaper in your rooms can break the fourth wall. Forgot. Oh, well.
Yes.
Now you know that, or you knew that. So, you can only break down the fourth wall, Aiden, by tearing down your wallpaper, then putting it back up again.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Tori.
You're very welcome.
This guy is very impatient. He's got a point, you know.
Anyways, I need to get to Faye's room. So...
Oh, yeah, hey, roll back the wallpaper. I think you should roll mine. I grab mine and just roll it back up as well. On to Faye's room.
Alright. Faded. Ready for what your door looks like?
Yes.
Okay. So, Faded. Your door looks like a normal dorm room door. Except... there is a certain symbol on it. A symbol on that door which has spoke volumes of generations. Two symbols, in fact. One above and one below. The one above speaks of generations since the beginning of time. These generations have spoke volumes in a shaped history as a whole, defined everything. This is the top symbol.
Bro, that looks like Assassin's Creed.
It is Assassin's Creed.
My gamer knowledge.
And then, there is another one below it. So, below it is another one that also speaks generations, has fought back invaders throughout time and history from all different forms of shapes and sizes, having originated from the very beginning of the end of the samurai, all the way, of course, beginning from the original Mongol invasions of Japan. This is the symbol below the top one. You enter your room. And when you enter your room is unnaturally large. It's like a gymnasium of sorts. There's sections of parkour that you can use. It looks like an assassin's den mixed with something else. There is, of course, a whistle on a nightstand next to an average-looking bed. And, of course, your Coke-fueled coffee.
I quickly run to the coffee and just chug it down.
You chug it down, and it has enough coke and enough caffeine to just kick enough to keep you awake all night.
Oh, that's the kicking spot.
Anyways, you then see the whistle. It is half black, half white. But actually, no, wait. Let me rephrase that. It is a whistle that's completely black, but with a skull on it. The symbol that is on... The symbol that is on the whistle looks something like this. Hold on. Let me get it.
It's the racist whistle.
Of course. So, this is what's on the whistle. Finally, I got it. It's the racist whistle. This is the symbol that's on the whistle, but it's painted white on the black. And there's a note next to it, and it says, Eric, Destiny, next with the note on it.
Wait. This is... I grab the note quickly.
You open it, and it says, My dear Destiny, your training will begin with me after your ultimate training sessions tomorrow. And for the next few days, that is. You will undergo the first part of your training, but afterwards, I want you to meet me in a special place. And then you get a map. There is a map of the island, and there's an X marking a specific spot of the danger zone up towards the top left corner. So, I want you to meet me there. There I will not be wary. My demon dog outfit. I will be wearing what I was born in. I will be wearing what I've been trained to be. I have always been and always will be a ghost. And now I can pass that knowledge to you. I can't wait to see your face again. It's been so long, even when writing this, and as Kokichi delivers it to your room, I feel some level of distraught. I know that there's a spirit tormenting you. The Emperor told me. But no matter what, even in your darkest times, even when there is no hope, keep on fighting. I will teach you how to combat evil spirits of the damned, and give you the ability to see them, even when you can, when others cannot. I will teach you how to be a skilled swordsman, beyond any of your belief. I will make you ghost, much like my father, your grandfather, has done for me. Thank you. Thank you so much. I can't wait to see you again. Your father, your loving father, Eric Su-Chung Destiny.
Bro, why am I actually crying?
Eric Jaeger.
Shut up!
Bro, not Eric Jaeger. Not Eric Jaeger.
An emotional moment. Oh, you're ruining it. Okay, so back to it. I hold the note close to my chest as I sit down on my bed.
Sit down on your bed. As you look across your bed, you see something. Armor. This armor looks weird and different. It's completely pitch black armor. It looks like a mix between samurai armor and futuristic and power armor. Much thinner, though. It is, of course, looks very futuristic. Upon this armor is a skull mask. And next to it, next to this piece of armor, is a sword, a katana, and of course, a kashi as well, a smaller katana. And of course, there's a big sign behind it saying, you will need this for training, and your day from this day forward will be And it's been cut off. And written under it is Fatalina Sushong.
Oh god, not, not the board giving me a name too. Oh god.
Behind you though, on the other side of your bed. Behind you though, on the other side of your bed is something different. It is white modern day Assassin's Creed garments and robes, along with a hidden blade. A note on your hidden blade. Note on the hidden blade directed to you. And on the note, it says, your real mother.
My real mother?
You open the note that says, Little Fatalina. I know that's not what you like to be called. As I've heard, and as the many eyes and ears that follow you around that I asked. And I asked again to watch you. But that is your birth name, Fatalina, as I have gifted it to you. Of course, your grandfather also had a say in it, but this is my gift to you, and I hope you choose the path of the Assassin's Creed, like I was born in. You were born in this path, but as you were stripped away from my hands, and at the day of your birth, by the menace known as Alaban al-Sufar. I'll never forgive him for that. And if I were to use the Black Blade again, it would be on him. Stay strong, my little Fatalina. Your mother. And it has the symbol of the Irish branch of the Assassin's Creed.
Wait. Real mother? No. No, 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 no. I have to murder her? Are you kidding me?
You stare at your garments, or your assassin's garments, that she has gifted you. So you have to choose, Faded. Will you walk the way of the ghost, or will you dart in the shadows alongside the assassins?
Oh, God.
You're gonna we will have to wait for that on Saturday! I'm moving practice to Sunday, by the way. I forgot to mention that. Practice is on Sunday instead of Saturday because I have stuff going on Friday. That's why. Go ahead.
Also, before I say, or you can either walk the path of the Ligma Clan.
The Ligma Clan! Shut up!
Toriel. Stop leaving me on cliffhangers! Stop!
You're more important than you think you are.
Dude, every time when it's my turn, it's always the end of the session because you said, and we'll leave that to the next one!
I feel bad for Faden, not gonna lie.
Why? Because she's the main character out of the rest of you.
Yippee! I'm the main
character! Quick question. First of all, is the Zombie King allowed in the Ultimate District?
Is the Zombie King allowed? He can't get to the island because he can't find it.
Alright, well, once we get to him, I will show him the direction of the island, let him fly over there, come to my room, and just break the fourth wall, okay?
Alright, guys. Sorry to bail on you early, but...
Wait, hold on. Answer the four questions before you go, okay?
Okay.
Alright, so first question, what was your favorite part about today's session?
Definitely when I called Ishimaru gay again.
Alright.
I'm not gay!
That's always a good part. Anyways, Mondo will react the same way if you call him gay. Anyways,
No, I'll probably get my nose broken.
You probably will.
Anyway.
Second question. What was your least favorite part about today's session?
Probably when I thought I was going to go into another boss fight.
But you're the main character. Obviously, I'm going to shower you with boss fights.
Of course. Thank
you. Until you get the memo.
I really fucking appreciate that.
Until you got the memo that you were the main character. And it seems that now you got the memo. I think it's now is a good time, because guess what? We just ended the prologue, by the way. We just ended the prologue. We're entering
chapter. All right, fine.
Yeah, baby! You know, that's what I've been waiting for! That's what it's all about!
Woo. I thought it was gonna take us a year, not gonna lie.
Now, the prologue's shorter than the rest. The longest chapter's chapter 2, because the thing is, you gotta figure out something when it comes down to chapter 2. You'll be blindly doing missions, trying to figure out the main quest.
Anyways, moving on to the third question.
Alright, question 3. What would you like to see in future sessions?
I really, really fucking want this. I want to start my romantic relationship with Rio on Saturday.
It can start because you'll immediately be set into free time.
Oh, great. Then we can start it, basically.
Yay!
Fader's character is just lying on the ground with some hip thrusting, like, baby, come on, ride with me!
I was tempted to ask my character, I was tempted for my character to ask Joe, hey, where's Rio?
you mean the fox girl you want to fuck so much? Well, she's on her way here. That's exactly what he'll say.
Anyways, and the final question, my favorite character?
Yes, MVP character of the session, go.
Ishimaru. No explanation.
Ishimaru, really? With the barely any screen time? I'm not gay!
That's my favorite time. Every time I hear that, I'm Frosty, I'm sorry, this is going to put so much more work on you, but every time Ishimaru says, I'm not gay, you have to put a counter. I'm sorry.
I am currently holding off Avon right now, because you're actually mad at Avon. You are literally not the main character.
So, what happened? Avon's my antagonist. Avon's my antagonist.
So what do you say would be your support?
My support would probably be Rio.
I'm sorry.
Your real favorite character is Rio?
No. That's my support character.
Oh, your support character.
Yeah, my antagonist is Avon so far, and my,
Really? Avon's your antagonist?
Yeah. He's annoying.
Your support isn't your antagonist. Oh, your antagonist is Avon. Avon's like, yeah! God fucking damn it! I actually tried this time!
I said for now. I didn't say it would be set in stone. I said for now.
And she didn't join his asset, and that should be your antagonist.
Okay,
yeah, after I become Avon, he's going to be my new support along with everyone else, and then my real antagonist will be the Torn Assassin.
Alright, so, Faden. Fifth question, since we're at the end of the chapter. This only happens at the end of chapters. There's a fifth question. So, this is a 2-in-1. The best character of the chapter, and what was your favorite moment of the prologue? You can answer
that anyway. My favorite character out of the entire prologue.
Yes.
That's tough. There's a ton of good ones. I'm gonna have to say it again, but I'm gonna go with Ishimaru because you already know.
Of course. He's only been.
I'm not gay.
Not gay!
Alright.
That's gonna be something you're gonna
do. Yeah, I'm gonna have to head out.
Hold on, what about the favorite moment before you go?
Oh no, for now?
For prologue. In the prologue.
Probably when I started taunting the Torn Assassin, like, get fucking wrecked, you tiny piece of shit.
And then he just punished you at the end.
Yup, and I'm like, oh, karma.
The fucking Torn Assassin does a wombo combo on your ass.
Happy feet, stick man, punch.
Alright, Faden, have a good one. See you Saturday.
Yeah. Alright, bye.
Alright, now let's go in proper order. Starting with basically, what was your favorite part about today's session?
Favorite part?
Yes.
Probably, you know, seeing Fate fight the Torn Assassin again.
Huh. That was a good part. Ah, I'm eating chips right now, that's why my speech is so delayed. Anyways. Frosty.
Oh, yeah?
So, what is your favorite part about today's session?
Every time the Faded gets traumatized.
Every time?
I got it.
She's gonna get a lot of trauma because she's the main character. There's a reason why she's called EX-101, because she's EX-101.
Meanwhile, Aven has main character syndrome and just fucking mad. I tried everything to be the main character.
Everything!
Aven, just be glad you just have a look, alright?
You're a fucking dad, bro.
Aven just flipped me off. I'm just...
Anyways. Fluffy, favorite part about today's session?
What? Can you repeat it?
Favorite part about today's session. It's all right.
I like the backstory part. I also liked when it... Actually, my favorite part was when, they were... It was the almost boss battle, but it was... But then they took it away.
The almost boss battle.
Nagito Komaida. Nagito enters the chat.
Hello, it's me, Nagito Komaida.
I can see actually Ryo and Nagito actually getting along. I can see them getting along.
Maybe later down the line, yep. Anyways, Octo, here we go. What's your favorite part about today's session?
One, all right, I got like two favorites.
All right, go
number
ahead.
Number one, the horrible musical. Due to the audio.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
That was a fail that I did not expect to happen. I'm sorry.
Hold on. What was it again? Because your fan was going, oh!
It was Grace the Roof.
It was Space... I have fucking hearing problems, dude. What the hell, man?
Second of all, they just call it Ichimaru Day all the time.
Oh, man. That's what you said. Another day!
Personally, not the big Aven said in the books.
Oh, I'm excited for chapter one, honestly. I think you're gonna start on my
I wouldn't save it for chapter one.
It's gonna be amazing how things are gonna start.
Chapter one's gonna have a lot of shit in it. You're gonna love it.
But how it starts is gonna be interesting because of what specific characters you're gonna do anyways.
You're finally gonna leave the island at chapter one.
Oh my god, yay!
Wait, we're leaving the island?
You're gonna leave the island, yeah.
What?
Only temporarily.
Only temporarily. Fucking. Even not saying we know the way from Moana, bro.
You're gonna go on a mission.
Alright, okay, but can we bring Angie along for the musical?
Angie is important
for
when you kill bosses. That's all I'm saying.
Angie!
Exactly, Angie Yanaka. And also, Correkio's also important for when you kill bosses.
Well, I guess we'll get Aven singing alone once more. Tricky. And the island of Jane, we cross the sea.
Anyways, let's continue with questions. Basically, what was your least favorite part about today's session?
Probably, literally just how Jiro was trying to confront Ryo about how she is.
Spitting facts. Hold on, what is his name from Cyberpunk?
Wake the fuck up, right? You gotta see.
Let's see, it's that one scene from Cyberpunk Edgerunners. It's with
David Martinez.
Oh, I know exactly who he is, yeah. Hold on. Talk about Atom Smasher. It's that one scene with Atom Smasher and David just looking up at each other, and Jiro's like, Atom Smasher looking down on fucking Rio, really confronting her of all her problems.
Yeah, clearly in Rio's eyes, she literally despises Jiro completely.
Bro, fucking
Atom Smasher.
Basically.
What? However. Oh my god.
However.
No!
You tempted me. You tempted me. You know I have plans for basically, and Jiro already set them, or foreshadowed them.
You motherfucker. I'm gonna...
I have devious plans. I have devious plans for this campaign.
Really? Tell me this. Will they get to reunite?
Yes, they will. I'll give you that.
Yes.
Basically, be prepared to sing.
And by the way, when you two reunite, it will be after one of the most badass scenes I have planned.
You know what his ultimate talent is, right?
No, I do not yet, because I don't have a backstory on basically yet, but...
I can send it to you.
You will get to see something that Faded will do if she takes this route. That will absolutely be the most badass thing ever.
I can send you his backstory, though. I can send you his backstory.
Good. Do you want me to give you a little hint on what I have planned for basically to do if she picks this specific route?
Actually, no.
Hint.
You want a hint?
Yeesh. Oh, Barry Hill's here.
Oh, shit. Barry Hill's here.
Barry Hill.
All right. Barry Hill. So here's your hint. All right, you want a hint?
Please.
Chainsaw Man.
Bruh.
No. I'm gonna send you a video, actually. I think it's better to do it in video than it is.
Okay. Can I keep an eye out for my DMs?
I'll do it through the chat, but do not say anything.
I won't. I'm good at keeping my mouth shut.
Alright. Here we go. Do not say anything, just watch it.
Why is it?
That's what I have planned for Faden.
Okay, question. Why is it a Super Mario Bros. Movie clip?
Huh?
Do you want me to just tell you basically his ultimate talent to get that out of the way?
I know. Or no, I have planned his for Faden. I have that planned for Faden. If she picks
basically his ultimate talent, he's the ultimate samurai.
That is actually based. That makes a lot of sense. Anyways.
Yeah, you think?
Continued on with this, Frosty. What is your least favorite part about today's session?
Speak, Frosty.
Puerto Rican fan blowing.
When I did it for a time.
Yeah, I'm right next
to you. You have free time tomorrow. You'll get the opportunity to see Rentaro, especially during the breakfast scene, where every ultimate in the island comes together. We'll get there when we get there.
Frosty. Are you gonna try to get Rentaro to screw you? Oh my god.
You'll probably do it.
Oh my god.
He's fucked worse.
No.
In this timeline.
Another confrontation. She'll probably get confronted by Makoto.
Yep. Anyways, Fluffy, what is your least favorite part about today's session?
I'm not sure. Maybe, like, before the backstory.
Before the backstory?
I think. I don't really remember that part.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure you weren't here for it.
Yeah. Other than that, I don't really have a least favorite.
Frosty.
Alright. Frosty, you are so down bad. You are down horrendous.
Look, Frosty, I may be bisexual. Look, Frosty, I may be bisexual, but I can at least control my dick.
I do have some rizzing plans for Rio, though. I do have some way. I have something.
Pretty sure Rio and Faye will get along very well.
I know. I have plans. Like, say if Rio's high, I'm gonna have her like start to raise up characters.
Of course. Here we go. Go ahead, Octo.
My least favorite part.
Oh my god, Frosty!
The fucking thing, like the fucking area I was in, kind of botched the music thing. So
the boss music.
No, the musical thing.
Oh man, the
I love it and I hate it because I love it.
It was good. It was just
it was
I
good.
I couldn't understand a word.
It was good, but your voice was like 2 pixels per minute.
Yeah.
Just record. I want you to actually do a proper vocal recording and.
All right. I'll watch the recording.
All right. Once I get back to West Virginia, I could probably record it there since.
All right.
I have like.
Good. Anyways. Yeah. Back to basically.
That will also apply to the.
Oh, you had another one.
No, I was gonna mention that I will be also applying to Biakia lines because I'm not doing this shit in Puerto Rico, bro. I'm being for real.
You're right. Anyways, basically.
Oh, balls.
So, third question, what would you like to see in the future, in future sessions?
What do you think?
You want to get knee-deep into fading, don't you?
Well, I do want to see, you know, like, their Rio and Faye's relationship to develop, but I do want to see the reunion between Rio and her brother, so.
That would be good to see, too. It would be a very emotional scene, too, when it happens. Because, obviously, you know what I'm planning. It's gonna be, it's not gonna be easy.
Well, I'm gonna watch the video after this, so I'll know soon. I'll know as soon as I watch it.
Of course you will. Anyways, Frosty, what would you like to see in future sessions? And I swear to God, if you say I want to see Rantaro fucking me. I swear to fucking God.
He also says he maybe wants Celeste to fuck him too now.
Of course. Say something.
You horny bastard. Just,
you horny motherfucker. I want to see Rentaro and Celeste.
It's because you want to get dominated by them. Be honest. You want to be dominated.
Of course. My husband and wife, respectively.
Real. You want to get dominated by them, that's all you want.
Yeah, you just want to be domed. That's just the end of it. It's alright.
You can. Give off dom energy. They both give dom energy, so.
You can, but you have to get through Hifumi first for Celeste.
Yeah, true.
Anyways.
Hifumi would do anything for Celeste, let's be honest.
He's her bodyguard now.
Am I not surprised?
Anyways, Fluffy. Well, what would you like to see in future sessions?
I want to see more character relationships, dynamics.
You want to see more character dynamics?
I like the battles.
You love the battles? Of course, the knight loves the battles. Because you're usually the one who carries them.
The knight is the giga chad.
Yeah, the chad who carries the team in battles.
Luffy is the team carrier. He's the party carrier.
I'm gonna also make Faded. Faded. What if you're seeing this video? There's the reason why you got that whistle. But Fade, well, whenever she goes to sleep, I'm gonna give her the opportunity to summon one of you into to battle with her. Battle a Torn Assassin. I just imagine just this is how the interaction with the Torn Assassin and Fluffy would go.
Oh, you're approaching me. Instead of fleeing and running away like most, I can't beat the shit out of you without getting closer. Ho ho. Then come as close as you like. They both deal walk to each other.
No, Fluffy would just proceed to help Faded Soul the Torn Assassin.
Faded. Oh my god. No, this can't be real.
I will take your soul. Fluffy, catch his hands, bitch.
Honestly.
I shall slay you in the holy name of the Novacelic family.
I will do it, Princess Nevermind.
I like to just imagine Ada challenge the Torn Assassin to a round of melee.
Ava just pulling out, that's all, folks.
Ava just put out the all out, folks.
That's all, folks.
That's all, folks.
Is that curtains closed?
That's all, Faded.
Yes, sir.
Anyways, Octo, here we go. What would you like to see in future sessions?
More opportunities for musical numbers.
They will come, especially when you get that ultimate perk.
Yes. When you
do get it.
And also, like, I guess in the future, I kind of want to show, like, one member, like, my room. And just like, oh yeah, by the way, say hi. It's a scary
one. Sure. Anyways, final question. Actually, two more questions. Holy crap. Okay, back to basically, well, MVP character. MVP character of the session.
Taka, no context.
Of course. Are you not gay?
Yes, you are.
No, I'm not.
You're like dick in your mouth.
There's literal femboy right here.
Yeah, because he had a reason to be a femboy. He was bullied. I'm reading about your dollar.
Besides, what was the brat's name again? Lyrical. She said she saw you sucking off Mondo.
What?
Who the fuck is Lyrical?
What? Wait, you mean that little girl that's been hanging around Jiro all the time?
Yes.
No! That was supposed to be our secret buddy time!
Your secret buddy!
Wait.
For our only mans!
The only man.
Only man?
Only man.
By the way, we might have a special guest appearance coming in on Saturday. A new character.
Oh, yeah. I already know.
It better be Peter Cullen.
Someone gifted you Nitro, Frosty? Someone just gifted Frosty Nitro.
Yeah.
What?
Someone just gifted Frosty Nitro. Someone gifted Frosty Nitro.
I'm guessing just cuz.
Probably just cause, let's be honest. Serious.
Okay,
like BFFR.
So,
BFFR.
I'm gonna get a radio flashback here, but...
Okay, her your sugar baby really does pay off. Really fluffy. Really fluffy. Being a sugar baby really does pay off.
Anyways, let's continue with questions, because we got one more question after this one. Alright, Frosty. MVP character of the session. Faded's trauma. That's crazy. Nah, you can't just do her dirty like that.
Nah, bro. Nah, shit, tripping.
All right, Fluffy. MVP character.
It's a hard one. I ignore my people screaming in the background.
It's alright.
I like Jiro, I guess.
Jiro? Nice. Another Jiro W. Alright.
Yes.
Alright. So, Octo, MVP character of the session.
Alright. So, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, this will change. This might change. But,
okay.
I think Faden might be the MVP character.
Either nice.
Either her, or I forgot the guy. Mr. Freeman.
Mr. Freeman?
I'm pretty sure he has more lore, because now my character exists in your world. So,
yeah.
No.
He does have a lot of lore behind him. He also is an unlockable boss for the end game.
Can I work with him?
I don't know. That's up to you to decide.
How much would you pay me?
You don't need to pay me anything. I don't... Sorry, chips in my throat. God, I'm dying. I need a drink. Anyways.
Hold on. I just casually like how this guy is just going on a monologue and it goes with Toriel's voice.
Alright. Back to basically. Question number 5. MVP character of the prologue, and what's your favorite part of the prologue?
MVP character of the prologue, Jiro.
Yeah, why?
My favorite moment. Okay. When Jiro adopted Lyrical.
That was a pretty heartfelt moment of the prologue. It will just keep on coming. And coming and coming and coming. Come?
I wish I was on my PC so I could put on the Come Monster soundboard.
Oh, wait. Yeah, we still have it.
Thank you.
Oh, yeah. So we found a lady store soundboard on my server. Oh, God. It's cursed. All right.
Frosty. MVP character of the prologue. I need a drink at one point. And favorite moment. Ugh. God. Oh. Every time Faden met the Torn Assassin. Is that MVP moment or MVP? Yeah, and the favorite moment of the prologue? It faded Strama, of course.
He's gonna say yes.
You just love the Torn Assassin, don't you?
You just like people see... Frosty just likes having seen characters get trauma.
Of course. Of course it does. You know what I should do?
Have a trauma counter.
Torn Assassin ASMR.
Oh my God.
Hey little baby, how you doing, my girl?
Come and hang up that computer call and come kiss me on my hot mouth.
The Torn Assassin saying that he faded.
Alright, Fluffy. MVP character of the prologue and favorite moment.
MVP character, Aven.
Let's go! Why?
Aven was just so funny. Like, when he got thrown by Faded.
When he got thrown by Faded, when he got his shit beaten by Faded.
The Rock.
He just keeps getting beaten up by Faded.
Just the Rock.
Aven, just knock it off. Just leave Faded alone. Leave Faded Town alone.
But she's like a mother.
A mother that throws you?
I mean, that's actually very accurate to Romanian mothers throwing their babies off a bridge. Anyways, what?
What? Anyways,
Fluffy, what's your favorite moment?
Favorite moment? I'd say the battle with the reptile guy in the first one.
Ooh, the initial boss fight, huh? The gateway boss.
Yes. That was great.
Or what? You had an ore in there?
No, I didn't have an ore.
Oh, okay. So the reptile boss fight. That's a pretty good moment, yes. Too. It really shows you the scale of how weak you guys are in this hostile
world. Yeah, we just died.
Yeah, you died, but hey, you actually are pretty skilled. And by you guys, I mean Aven.
Well, Fluffy's character is the Giga Chat of the group, so.
Not in that battle.
Fluffy, yeah. Not in that battle, but Fluffy was beating the shit out of Hellhounds, literally beating Hellhounds with Hellhounds.
Yeah.
Faded. No, okay, hold on. So, Roger, Aven, or Giga Chat?
You are right. Roger and Aven aren't Chad. No, Roger and Jiro, both of them are muscular Chads.
And Rio's a bit.
Yep. Anyways, good old Octo. You're the last one to answer. MVP character of the prologue and favorite moment of the entire prologue.
Alright. Well, Faded and Jira were close contenders for favorite MVP character of the prologue. I would have to go to my homeboy Koichi. Shout out to my friend. Actually, no, scratch Koichi, Roger.
Roger?
Roger. Mm-hmm.
A few moments Rogers was here, Rogers was kicking ass.
Yeah, Roger was the fucking doom guy of our group, man.
Giga-chan.
And my favorite moment, honestly, was the laboratory walk. It's like the laboratory scene.
Yeah. Why was that your favorite moment?
Well, shit. I mean, like, I'm gonna be honest, it kind of like build-ups. So it explains a lot about the lore of our world, and it should have been referenced here, but that's a little bit lowest. Honestly, I wish I got real with Fade, not real with Fade though. Got real with Rio. Like, hey, I'm sorry for what I said back there, all that stuff. I lost my anger, I lost my temper, and I should have been more patient with you, all that stuff.
And then you're interrupted by Casper the Unfriendly Piss.
Yes.
The Mondo be dragging him. Mondo dragging him.
Mondo dragging him. You will never walk
to the mega gay zone. To the mega gay zone.
Wait, why are you taking me? Oh, you're gonna love this. No, not the mega gay zone.
The mega gay zone, motherfucker.
Oh, you're man.
Gonna go where Gundam went.
Okay, so big announcement before I end off. So, I realized that if I'm going to be able to do the episodes and animate them properly, I can't do that and spend a lot of my time that I had on working on Hope Justice Sprites. I'm going to finish the first one, but I want somebody to start to work on the Hope Justice Sprites in my stead. I'm going to hold a competition in Danganronpa Art to see who would be the best at making the Hope Justice sprites. Get every single Nagito sprite, make them, replicate them into Hope Justice's design, and the winner will be credited in Saucer Loss.
Oh boy.
So, for the contest, do we just have to do one or all of them?
All of them.
All of them. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, I'm gonna crack open my old iPad. that I rarely use.
I'm gonna go get a cold one. Anyways, thank you all for watching once again. Back to the Jacksonville podcast. And we will see you guys on Saturday. Actually, I will be publishing this video on Sunday alongside the other video on the same day. And that will be also a day of practice, too. Anyways, I will start the competition tomorrow. Or actually, no, I'll start the competition on Saturday. I'll get it up and running. But thank you guys so much for tuning in. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Say bye, everybody.
Bye. Bye.